Yo, yo, it is the Panda of Pandemonium. As you can see, we got the rest of the crew here. Our D&D guest, Ron, we got Rod, we got Vocab, missing Jay right now, so we're waiting on him. We are here. We are in full effect. Gentlemen, how's the week been? How's everything been going for you?
Man, can't complain.
Can't complain at all.
No complaints. Sounds like a good week to me. We are, as you all know, we are going to be playing some D&D today. Hopefully, we're still waiting on Jay. But for now, let's set up a couple things. Rob, you mentioned Zelda.
Oh yeah, it's coming out next Friday. Mm-hmm. Tears of the Kingdom, probably the most anticipated Switch game since the original Breath of the Wild.
Yeah,
people definitely have been waiting for it. I'm gonna get it Friday myself. I'm doing digital.
Okay.
Last time I did physical, but I didn't know how the store drives worked back then, so I got Breath of the Wild, and I enjoyed it. That was the first Zelda game I ever beat. So I'm really interested in to see where the story goes.
Is canon.
Yeah, it's a sequel. This is the first sequel since I think Majora's Mask.
Gotcha.
First sequel since Majora's Mask. A lot of people have been excited to see what the next step is, the way the game ended. It ended on kind of a good note, too, with they defeated Ganon. Mm-hmm. But from the trailers and everything, it looks like Ganondorf is involved somehow, some way. They're going, as I'm not the biggest Zelda lore person, but
gotcha.
They're going into the sky. That's a gimmick. So they're going into the sky, the Sky Kingdoms, I guess. I know this was like a Skyward Sword game a couple of years back. Okay. Maybe some references to that game, but people seem excited. I mean, I took the day off from work because I want to play it myself. Probably do some other things, but it should be fun. I mean, people have been happy to have the Switch OLEDs that just came out about 2-3 weeks ago.
Okay.
So I was telling people, like, if you haven't gotten a Switch yet, get it before Zelda come out, because there's probably going to be a little bit of a shortage because people are just coming back for Zelda or upgrading their Switches to the OLED. I can see that.
So if people are trying to find copies of the OLED version.
Yeah, I can see that because, I mean, the Switch is almost 6-7 years old at this point, but, I mean, it's still going strong.
Gotcha. No, understandable. And actually, I got on the background just some playthrough that they've got as of right now from Nintendo America, so you all can kind of see a few, just as we're talking about it, a little bit of how that looks.
Yeah, they got some new features, but it is pretty much, they got some new gimmicks in here with Link. Mm-hmm. And horse riding, that was kind of fun. Once you figured out how to get a horse in Breath of the Wild, oh my god, that changed how you moved in that game. Oh my goodness, it was like night and day.
I bet. I remember because I played it. I think I actually played it with Duran. He's the one who showed it to me at first. Because I'm not a huge Zelda fan at all. I never have been. Like, I have respect for the game and the history behind it. It's just I never got into it. It's one of those that I missed, you know? But when he showed it to me, he didn't have the horse yet at the time. But just like this part, this whole climbing thing with the gay fatigue gauges, I was like, who would have thought of that? Like, I never would have thought of that in a game.
It's something we're spoiled with gaming-wise. We're spoiled
Endurance. Like, you can just do whatever you want without worrying about your physical strength or anything like that.
And that was the whole keyword. But see, this is the new gimmick. You can hit the items, and then you go up, up, and up, and up, and up to the sky. So that's the new thing.
Gotcha.
And even people going to have fun with this. Like, one of the new abilities is you can make your own items. You can make your own cars, your own gliders. I think even in a demo here, they're going to show you how to make a boat. If you watch this whole presentation, They show you how to make a boat with the new powers.
Oh, wow.
So you're going to probably, if you saw how creative people were in the first game.
Yeah, yeah.
So people are going to get creative. You're going to see some creative stuff, but that's the main reason I'm like looking forward to this. People, there's some creative folks out there. I wish I could stream this, but I'm not a Zelda person, so I probably wouldn't be the best person to stream with this, honestly.
Look, it's about playing the game. Because, like, trust me, as many people as I've seen play different games, especially, like, platformers, I mean, you're going to die. You know what I mean? Mm-hmm. This is one of those things that's going to happen in those games. So, honestly, if you enjoy the game, that's what it's about. Bottom line. Because I know good and well in August, like, you all are talking about this one now. In August, when Armored Core drops, I'm taking the day off. Like, I don't do that often for a game.
I don't blame you. I don't blame you there.
But for that one, I'm taking the day off. Elden Ring creators are remaking. This is probably one of my top two games of all time. Is Armored Core, the Armored Core series, and then, of course, Tekken, right? And those also are games that are like, they define my childhood. If I buy any two games. It's funny, we talked about that last week, or 2 weeks ago. And I forgot all about it at the time because the game hasn't been out since PS2, Armored Core. Yeah, I don't think we've had one since PS2, maybe early PS3. That's it. And we've got two systems since then. So I'm stupid excited for that. I'm super excited for those to come out.
Wait, did they announce the, speaking of games, did they announce the release date for Tekken 8 yet?
I do not believe we have. No, not yet. Let me double check here. But I don't remember seeing anything here.
Because I know Street Fighter is June. I know Street Fighter is June.
Street Fighter is June. They're talking about early 2024, late 2023. So no actual date yet.
That'll probably be a stealth Christmas launch. Yet. I wouldn't be surprised.
It would make sense. Although, next year is 2024. Is there anything else that's coming out 2024, though?
Maybe Call of Duty, but that's probably the only thing I could think of.
Yeah.
Nintendo hasn't released anything outside of 2024. I know Pokemon has an expansion pack coming out, I think, early spring, too. So
let's see here. Well, I'm thinking movie-wise, right? Movie-wise, they're saying, like, Deadpool, Wicked, Joker, Godzilla versus King Kong.
Hopefully Gladiator, we got the writer's strike going on too. So I know Blade got affected with that.
Blade got affected. Yeah, Blade definitely got affected. Half the Thunderbolts got affected by it too.
I didn't know about Thunderbolts. Damn, I was looking forward to that one too.
Thunderbolts got affected by it. I don't know what they're gonna do with Captain America, or if that's gonna be affected or not. Sonic will.
Yeah, I mean,
I'm pretty sure Sonic will. Blade, probably. Yeah, we know that one.
No, I know they have the Knuckles spinoff coming out soon. That's probably already finished. Someone said they get the
script. I doubt that's finished. But no, you're right, though. Yeah, that one's coming out too.
Let's
see here.
Shout out to the writers, because pay them writers. That's, I'll keep it simple. Pay them writers what they owe. Just pay them.
I don't. So, as someone, and you as well, as someone who writes, right? The pun. But as somebody who writes, it's interesting to know that we're still having this issue on the professional level that we're trying to get to. You know what I mean?
Mm-hmm.
Like, I know we were talking about it with the whole voice acting thing and like all these studios and these production companies getting paid X amount of dollars, but the voice artists are being, you know, they're being penny and dimed. And to see that the writers are also having that same issue, like the whole entertainment industry at this point just needs an overhaul. Because the money's clearly not going to the people who are the creative minds that are giving us the entertainment. the money's not going where it needs to go. Like, how can you expect someone to keep giving you epic content and y'all don't want to pay them?
Exactly.
You know, some of these dudes that were talking about not being able to even pay their rent. And I'm like, hold up. How are you a Hollywood writer and you can't pay? I don't care if it is in California and you can't pay your rent, though.
No. You know what I mean? And then I don't know if you guys follow what's her name? Francesca Ransby. She used to be a writer. Like, she's a prominent female black writer. She had someone in one of my Facebook group posted something she posted the other day. She was like, someone was working on FX, one of their newest shows. I think it was called The Bear. They only made $5,000 for one season. Like,
right. And you know, good and well, people are there, the industry is making way more off of it. And now, I understand the whole, I do understand the piece about they're saying that numbers are kind of skewed due to streaming services and online. But even if it's viewed through a streaming service, you have a way of recording it, which means you have a way of monetizing it. You know what I mean? It's something's got to give. There's got to be some type of royalty kickback because people are watching these things. Now, after 10, 20 years, okay, I can understand it. You know what I mean? But that first, at least initial 10 years that you got something, I mean, even if you write a book, it is legally yours. If I'm not mistaken, the copyright is till so many years after your death.
That sounds right.
When you write. You know what I mean? So many years.
Yeah, so many years there's a lot death. Of Disney characters almost so public domain now.
Right, that are just now going to public. Exactly. Exactly. So, I mean, are the writers selling their scripts to the producers? Because if they are, then that's one thing, right? Which means they need to contract. They need to be paying attention to their contracts, just like the just like the vocal artists do. Mm-hmm. You know, you got to pay attention to your contract if that's the case. But if it's contractually in there, and most of the writers are unionized, which means there is a contract in place for the work that they do.
Oh yeah,
and yeah.
Like, I was watching, what was I watching? No, Chihiro, I was in a Facebook. Hey,
how's it going? Yeah,
I was in a Facebook group for Abbott Elementary. People were getting mad at Quiana Benson, the writer, because like, why is she picketing? Like, she's like, how come I still ain't writing the show? Like, she's a union writer. She got to be on strike
exactly.
too.
Exactly. Everybody. What was it? Neil Gaiman, the writer of Sandman. And for those who don't know, we're doing good. Appreciate you swinging by. Good. The writer of Sandman, that book has been out for forever. First off, like, Neil Gaiman has a dedicated following straight up. And the fact that he's picketing still, you know what I mean? Because he's part of the union. He's like, no, I honor what everybody's going through. This is ridiculous. And him also seeing it on this side, because now the show Sandman is a show. Cause before it was the novel. And then it went. You know, it was a graphic novel, if I'm not mistaken. But it's like it's thick as hell, bro. Like, the story is amazing. The show does not do it justice, hands down. The show for Sandman, as good as it is, does not even do the storyline
justice. But you can say that for a lot of book series too. A lot of
definitely
book series like that's probably one of the main reasons they're doing that Harry Potter reboot outside of, you know, the actors not wanting to do it anymore. Mm-hmm. It just makes logical sense to just reboot.
Yeah.
Like it's a logic thing. Like, even like, I know one of my favorite shows is Law and Order Organized Crime, and they're only having 13 episodes. And I'm thinking they were probably preparing ahead for the writer's strike. That's just a very,
that's possible.
Show. I want a lot of script heavy shows. I wouldn't be surprised to have lesser episodes this year. I wouldn't be surprised.
Yeah. Yeah,
I know. Even Abbott said I'll use Abbott as an example because I'm just in a good Facebook group with a lot of behind the scenes stuff.
Oh, you're good.
So they usually have 22. I wouldn't be surprised they're down to 18. I wouldn't be surprised you look every show.
I mean, about 4 or 5 you got to stop where you got the content for, you know. And if they, depending on how long it takes for them to get this strike, you know, to come to a compromise. My thing is, I've never understood why. I know the reason for the strike, and I understand the need for strikes on the union side, right? That part is not what I'm negating in any capacity, first off. Mm-hmm. But on the company side, you all, yes, you have a bottom line to deal with. But if you know, and these companies know, mm-hmm. you know what they're I mean? If you know you're raking somebody over the coals, just pay them what they worth.
Exactly. It's not that hard. I mean, to go on it on a different side of a spectrum here for just for a second here. NBA. NBA just signed another they just renewed their labor negotiations. I think they just renewed maybe 2 weeks ago, if I'm not mistaken, 2 weeks ago. Mm-hmm. And then I think for like another 10-year deal. Most of the sports leagues are almost 10-year deal at this point. It's easier for them to do the TV money, things like that. Mm-hmm. And I think the TV contracts and NBA, I think, are up either this next year, actually. So that's why they got the labor negotiation.
Right
before that, we can get the TV money and the way some of these NBA players, you don't want some of these guys online. Not now. Because they sort of smoked that LeBron, Chris Paul, and them did back when the last time they almost had a strike. Like, it was LeBron and them that really prevented them from going on strike last time. That was the big kicker there. Mm-hmm. Because the big dogs were at the table. And the union said, we're going to put the big dogs at the table. They're going to listen to the big dogs. They're not going to listen they'll listen to Chris Paul. Right. They will listen to LeBron James, but they're not going to listen to, I'll use Giannis just because it's easy. Like, he ain't that big dog yet. Like, you put Giannis and maybe, what's the other dude? Luka, the dude from Denver. I can't think of the dude's name right now, but
Jokic.
There you go.
Yeah,
you're not gonna bring them to the negotiating table, but you bring LeBron James, Chris Paul, and Dwayne Wade. That's a whole different story.
See, and that's the thing I'm not getting with a Writers Guild. Like, that's what's blowing my mind. This is the Writers Guild, which means 90% of the people you got are the big dogs. Who else is giving you content? Mm-hmm. Every show you have coming out, every movie you have coming, we're talking about Disney writers. We're talking about Marvel writers. We're talking about people who, for Netflix, are producing all of their biggest shows. With, like, I think Netflix, when they opened their own like studio basically and started diverting that pathway of, you know, hey, we're going to get our own series, you know what I'm saying? Forget everybody else. We'll still do those, but that's when they really started, I think, growing like they wanted to, is when they started having their own individualized Netflix only series. Bridgerton, for example, you know what I mean? Stuff like that. Like, those are like building cult followings to a degree. And y'all telling me y'all don't want to pay the people who's writing them for you? Like, we understand that those people are coming from other places. They were disenfranchised in one area, so they came to Netflix, right, to get their stories put out there. But if y'all are also not going to uphold the reason why they left, what makes you think they're not going to walk away from y'all?
Exactly. It's that simple. Like, when it comes to labor disputes, I'm always on the union side. So I remember growing up watching the NBA, and like, I didn't get it as a kid. I'm like, okay, why are they, like, I didn't get it. I was kind of signing with the owners because I just want my games back. I don't care. Like, I don't care. I just want my games back. But growing up and learning about some of this labor, key point, this is why education is important in school, because we need to learn about shit like this. But, going back to the writer stuff, like, these writers are producing all this content. Put it to you like this. This is going to do a little history lesson here. The last time the writers went on strike, what shows got very popular very fast? Think of three shows that got very popular very fast about 10 years
ago. And that was what? Was it
2013? You know, like, doing about 2010, 2012, around there.
It's been a little while since they've had a strike.
Think about what shows were big. Think about what shows got big. Reality TV, that got big because they didn't need writers for reality TV.
Right, because you don't need a writer.
Okay.
Yeah, 07, 08. Yep.
Yeah, that's when The Apprentice got big. That's how that show got big. Yep. See the domino effect that happened with that. But we ain't going to go into
that. You're not going to go into that, right?
That's a domino. But honestly, just pay the writers what they owe. Especially, and I didn't know they were not getting paid for streaming. That just seems kind of obvious. Yeah.
Certain amount. My understanding is that they get a certain amount contractually, but I guess the argument was that due to pirating or other things like that, there's no way to accurately guarantee that. And I was like, I get that. I respect that. But my thing is, you have everyone under the sun has their own streaming site now. Netflix, Paramount, HBO Max, Hulu. You know what I'm saying? If you're on a platform, that platform is getting paid, whether it's through ad revenue for it being on there or from their particular fees, right? If a person watches a show or a movie on that platform, they deserve to get paid. They deserve to be monetized in some, I don't care, whatever the increment is. If, for example, let's say they make $50 off of a movie being watched on Hulu, right? Between the membership, the ad revenue, and whatever else they may have, right? Let's just say they get paid $50 per movie that gets watched. Of that 50, the production company, they should get something out of that, right? Because they made the movie, of course. Mm-hmm. So let's say 30% of it goes to them, right? Because all we're doing is streaming it. So let's say 30% goes to the production company. Of that 30%, at least 25% of that 25% of that 30% total, right?
You're going with that one. Okay, I see. I wouldn't have thought of that one, but
you know what I mean? Like, if they're getting 30% of the 50, then of that 30%, 25% of that 30% should go to the writer. Because without them, you don't have anything. Yo, what up? What up? How's it going? Appreciate you swinging by.
What up?
But I mean, that's just my take on it. You know, like there's a way to monetize everything. You give somebody an Excel spreadsheet, there's a way to calculate it all.
Oh, yeah.
Right. You know what I mean? Like, it's a given. It can be done. It's just people are getting lazy and not wanting to do the work.
Exactly.
Or they're trying to keep their cut larger than what needs to be. Same with any company, for the most part, unfortunately. People no longer do ethical business. It's sad, about the almighty dollar.
Sad facts. It's sad but true, but
you know,
some of these places they just rip people off, honestly. Like, I forgot who TikTok I was following. I was following, like, I don't know if I still follow this TikTok or not, but I remember I've stumbled my For You page, stumbled along to a writer, and he literally went over his residual checks, and the amounts were disgusting. He was like, "Oh, episode of Martin, I only got 50 cents for that." They literally sent him a check for 50 cents. I'm like,
"Yep, the paper costs more than what he wrote." And do you know how, first off, everybody's been to school here. How long did it take y'all back in the day to write a 5-page paper? Now it's different, right? We adults now. But back then, how long did it take y'all to write a 5-page
paper? 2 hours, maybe. Maybe 2 hours,
right? And that's on the short end, right? Some people, depending on how your mind works, it could take you the day to write a 5-page paper.
Depending on what the topic is, yeah.
Right, depending on the topic, right. If it's something that you liked, okay, cool. You know, maybe half the day if you don't get sidetracked, a couple hours. But otherwise, it might take you a day. That's one day of your life. If I'm getting paid by the hour, depending on how much I feel my life is worth, that's a day of my life that I got paid 50 cents for.
Right.
So I'm worth 50 cents for 24 hours of my life?
Right.
My essence? I ate more than 50 cents worth of stuff that day.
Hell yeah.
Yep,
you know what I mean? My water bill was more than 50 cents that day.
Yeah.
And water is what, 20 bucks a month? Like, you know what I'm saying? Like
it's disgusting. Like, and I get it too. Like, you gotta pay the writers. I mean, do we all want to watch The Apprentice? Do we all want to watch Love at the Lockup all the time? Do we all want to watch? Okay, Shaniqua, you would, but
yes, I mean, for some people, that is all they need. Yes, this is true. However, for the vast majority of us, we need a little bit of diversity.
Like, ooh, you know, now I'm thinking about something. I'm thinking about some shows that got canceled recently, streaming-wise. I know one of the ones I liked was on Peacock, like Vampire Academy. I wonder if that got canceled because maybe, like, I'm thinking a lot of these studios were anticipating the writer's strike.
Here we go. I got you. Here's what I was going to do. Let's take a big one, right? Let's do a Marvel movie.
Ooh.
So I was looking through it, and they're in general. This is, again, general numbers. They say they earn about 32K annually.
Okay, that's not bad. That's not too bad.
No. No, 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 no. No, that's horrible. That's horrendous.
Wait, wait. I'm 32. Talking about, is this just individual movies or just
the general? Her writer, right, the writer for the movie, right? For, let's say, I don't know, pick one. We'll say a bad one, Ant-Man, right?
Okay.
We'll say that. He made $32,000 that year as the writer for that movie, right? Average, like on the low end, average about between $32,000 and $50,000. Let's just say, okay. At $32,000, you're looking at about $15 an hour.
Oh yeah, I see what you're saying. Yeah,
at $32,000, at $50,000, you're looking at what about 20?
That's close to 22, 23.
Right, 22, 23 an hour.
Okay.
How much did Ant-Man make? Let's do the math. Let's pull those numbers.
Okay.
Let's see here. 622 million worldwide.
Shoot, I would throw the writers about, let's see, 622 worldwide. Going by 20-30%. Let's do 20-30% the way you said.
Worldwide. That's... You see what I'm saying?
You could throw them something on the back end. Like
you could toss them a cool, at least a cool 100K a year.
Right.
Maybe 50. You see 50K what I'm saying? Like I said, especially if you're waiting multiple movies, like, like that's 32,000 per every movie you're on, then I get that. They're not gonna spend every day writing one movie every day. See, I was thinking about it a different way.
How long would it take you? Would it take you to write? Think about you yourself. How long would it take you to write a novel? If that's all you're doing, let's say 80 to 100, let's say 100,000 words. How long do you think it would take you to write that? If that was your job,
probably 2-3. Probably I would say 6 months. Probably take me 6 months.
6 months to write it. Now the editing process.
You know what? I didn't factor in the editing. You got a point there.
Then the rewrite. Then the edit from that rewrite, and then the next rewrite, because you know you go through at least 7 iterations of this.
True.
You see what I'm saying? You spent a good year, minimum, on one story. Tiring it out to that level, right? Now, again, they have teams, so, you know, it's a little bit different than one person doing it themselves. Mm-hmm. But either way, you telling me they made $622 million, and I understand because I'm sure people are going to be like, well, what about, you know, the production costs and all of that? Okay, cool. If I say Ant-Man 2, let me see here. They said they made $622 million worldwide during the entire run. Ant-Man 2 production costs. Let's see here. They budgeted, the budget was $195 top side million. Okay, so the $622 million, $195 of that was budget for making the movie.
Yeah, you made your money back. You definitely made your money back.
They quintupled their movie back. Mind you, budget includes what they paid writers.
Oh, see, that should be a separate expense.
You got it. You see what I'm saying?
That should be a separate expense, like the back end, because if the actors are getting back in on that's another, I don't know how they'll throw that in there. Because certain actors,
and so the actors are getting more money than the writer. How is that? It's like it's the same principle as the lawyer gets paid more money than the teacher. Pause. I taught you how to do this. How are you making more money than me? Because without me, there is no you.
Exactly.
In every culture in this world, literally every country in the world, the teachers are paid more than most professions. Most, not all, of course. But more. You know what I mean? We spend 18% more, and this was like as of years ago. We spend 18% more on education yearly as a country than every other country in the world. Yet at the same time, we're like at the bottom percentage of educated countries. It makes it makes no sense. Where's the money going?
No,
it's going to education, but it's not going to educate.
That makes total sense. That makes total sense, man. Like, that's something like I've been kind of looking at this writer's strike thing, and I'm just like, I mean, if it just pay them what you owe, like, it's not that hard. Like, it can be, it's just basic. I can say basic accounting, but it's just basic figures, like we were just talking about earlier. It's just basic figures. If that is how you're going to do everything, because you can break it down a couple of ways here. Like I said, Ant-Man made $625. You mean you can't tell me you can have a block of like maybe $5 million up front for writers split, and then maybe like a certain percent, maybe whatever the residual is, maybe you get $200 every, or maybe $1,000 a month, like a residual.
And this isn't even royalties. Yeah, I mean, this is just the initial theatrical run. I don't know if that's true. You see what I'm saying?
Right.
That 622 was just the theatrical run, box office. That's not the video sales, the merchandise sales, the if there's a video game spinoff sales. None of that. None of that. What up, Jay? How you feeling?
Yeah, I was just waiting for y'all. Serious,
we was in a good discussion waiting for you. Talk about the writer's strike and everything. What's going on?
Yeah, that's what we're talking about.
Don't speak on strikes because I'm man. Look,
don't say less. we're pro union over here. We're all pro.
I'm trying to find me the perfect wallpaper for the day, y'all. Give me 1 second.
You good. But yeah, like that's the thing. So the fact that if you think about the number of people in Hollywood that are making money off of Hollywood, without the writers, there is no Hollywood.
Exactly. Like, Look what shows stopped immediately once the writers strike. Late night television, Saturday Night Live, they stopped.
Instantly.
Y'all lucky Matt TV ain't back on the air. Man, listen. There have been some rides already.
Already. Now, I will say this, and I hate to say this, but I'm going to say it. This is also an opportunity for those who are not unionized.
Oh, I've been seeing Twitter threads about that. I've been seeing since
you know what I mean.
Screenwriters are like, nope. If a studio comes here, you're an author. Do not cross that line.
That's the thing. They should not. But I'm not talking about studio. I'm talking about social media. So if you are again not unionized, however, you have an idea that can be an entertaining idea, possibly, right? That you want to put together yourself and put out there yourself. Right now is the perfect time to interject your brand of entertainment into the world. Why? Because the mainstream brands are all on hold, which means people need something to look at. You see what I'm saying?
Right.
I'm not saying in any way disregard anything that's going on with the union and the Writers Guild, right? That is 100. I got 100% respect for that. But we also got to find a way to get our name out there, right? So if you can put your own material on your social medias, right? If people are not watching the regular stuff right now, there's more eyes on other places where they can get their entertainment. And unfortunately, we know this world runs on entertainment.
And you know some people will take the money and cross that line.
Some will, and they should not. They should not. But this can be a way to get your following so that way when that union, that all the contracts are back together for the Writers Guild and the unions, you're now in a more prominent position to make a deal with a producer if that opportunity comes up. You get what I'm saying?
No, I get that. Like, if I was someone, like, if I had a series or something in mind, and I knew someone to write it, like, hey, I got this idea. I know you guys are on strike. I don't want to I don't want to step on any toes now. Can I just submit this idea and then have as like a negotiating for it? I want union writers on the contract.
I wouldn't even put it. I would not even put it out there. I literally would do like a Dragon Ball Z abridge and put it out myself on YouTube.
Oh, Team Four Sasa. Okay.
You see what I'm saying? I'm going to put my stuff out there because they're not watching TV, so they're going to go to YouTube. They're not watching TV, so they're going to go to, you know what I mean? Mm-hmm. To TikTok. Hey, Monty, how's it going? But what's they're going to go somewhere else. Yeah. It's just basically that this is a divergence of attention, right? And so because the attention is no longer on mainstream television movies because the writers are currently not writing, there are no shows. The people are going to look for something else to catch their attention. And if you've got something that'll hold their attention, that's gonna give you that niche.
Mm-hmm. Mama calling back. Ooh, fall.
You know, so it's not a negative per se, but it's just making the best of a bad situation.
Right.
So definitely
just a thought process.
Yeah, something to think about because honestly. You look at some of your favorite shows are gone, and then
think about streamers. If they're not doing that, they may go watch streams now. You know what I mean?
Oh yeah,
they may go watch something. There you go. So
you never know. Let's pray these writers get what they want. And we can get our shows back. Let's just pray for them. Like I said, that's what I'm hoping for.
I want them to get their money because they deserve it. Especially like I said, this is the position that I aspire to have. At some point in the near future, you know what I mean? Is a production writer, production level writer, personally for my own universe is what I would prefer. That's the goal. You know what I mean? I want to write my own universe of stuff that rivals Marvel. Because that's gonna happen. Just letting y'all know that now ahead of time, that's going to happen in the next 5 years. Just giving y'all a heads up. Just giving y'all a heads up. But that's to know that the people at the level I'm trying to get to are still not being given they flowers early. They say they're not giving they just dues. That's not cool. Like who wants to look at, hey, I want to be a firefighter, and then you realize firefighters don't make jack.
You gotta, especially some
you
of
know
them,
what I mean?
Like you can get the six figures, but you want to be there at least 10, 20 years at that level.
So if it's not something you really love doing, am I exactly. And don't get me wrong, it's not about being a millionaire, but you still want to do what you love doing and be comfortable.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
That's what it's about.
That's the goal in life. Like, exactly. Find something you're good at, make decent money, you're good, you're comfortable, and you're happy. Exactly. That should be the goal, but unfortunately, we're not in a society like that.
Unfortunately.
Yeah, so just pray for the writers, keep them in your prayers and thoughts. Hopefully we don't get like another Apprentice situation. Let's just hope like that. Or what happened to Heroes? I mean, that's what messed up Heroes.
Don't bring that up. Don't bring that up.
Honey, isn't that when that last strike happened?
Yep.
Yes.
Wow. Yes.
And that's funny because that's when I said that was like the show. Like it's so bad to the point. I thought about it one day and I got her to start watching it. Like we were actually.
I'm not gonna lie, I still have not watched it.
Neither. Yo. I heard what happened. I was like,
I've heard great things, I just haven't gotten around to it.
For what?
Thank you, dude.
Heroes.
What happened to Heroes?
Yeah, I ain't watched it.
That was a tragedy. If you like
anime, Heroes is just one of those shows, bro. It is a great show. The story was like new, but it was really, really good.
Well, yeah, Barry and Mary Jane. That's a good point, Monty. That was another one that got canceled. Good point.
Yeah. I remember it was a couple of Heroes, like a couple of the shows, weren't there? Like, or was it like seasons with different names?
There was like a main one and then a revival.
Gotcha. Yeah, Mary Jane. Yeah, there's a couple of shows that were
that Heroes. That the other Heroes is we don't talk about Bruno.
Oh wow!
It was. Yeah, you don't really need to watch it. It's fine.
Gotcha.
Just watch the first series, and when I said the villain in Heroes was just, bro. If you love anime, manga, comic books, you're gonna like Heroes. You might not like it most people. It's just the way that they brought the powers in and the type of powers and the I guess you would say the limits of the powers. Like, you have powers that that you will feel. Basically, My Hero Academia is what Heroes would have been if it was an anime of sort.
So just real life, like a real life version of it before, but not actually it.
If I would, I would not. I don't know if I can say it like this, but think about it like this. If you wanted to put how everybody started discovering quirks, I think Heroes would be how My Hero Academia started. Because people just started getting powers. It wasn't like
it randomly happened.
Yeah. Stuff just started happening.
Okay.
Alphas, and some people had powers for years. Oh my God.
That's a good point.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
That's a good point. That's
but how everybody been, man?
Yeah, we're good.
We're here, bro.
Yeah.
Oh, that's good. Vocab, how are you?
I'm not good, and I don't know why you would disrespect me and put that backdrop. I was waiting to say something.
For y'all, that is someone who has a dog in him. Jimmy Butler has the dog in him. I'll tell you that.
For y'all who don't know, as y'all do know, me and Vocab were the sports ones. I'm a huge Miami fan, and he's a diehard Knicks fan.
That's a fact.
And it's rare that we meet in playoffs like this.
It's very rare. What y'all did was just disrespectful.
My honey said,
when this man get on the court in the playoffs, just know he's not gonna let it go easy.
That dude's on some demon time. Man, I saw what he did in Milwaukee. Man, that was a coach, but
hey, hold on. Look, I'm gonna say this and y'all gonna laugh. Y'all remember what they said about Jordan being his dad, possibly. Hey, he's looking like him more and more.
Man.
But how about that Curry 50, though?
That Curry 50 was sick, though. Don't get me wrong. That Curry 50 was sick. But it ain't going to mean nothing if LeBron put him out.
No, you know, before we even started to low-key, I was watching the Boston and Philly game. Yo, Boston got robbed low-key of that last shot.
Yeah, I was watching that.
I believe it, man.
I was like
3-1.
I was like, back in the day, they would have counted that shot. I said, back in the day, they would have counted that shot.
Hear me out, though. I want Boston to win. And why I want Boston to win, because if we win, that means me and Monty. Me and Monty gonna have to go at it again. That's our rival right there. Cause she's a Celtics fan and I'm a Heat fan. Yeah. We had a rival going on for a little while. We gotta make up. What was that last year they put us out? Oh, we gotta make up for that.
I don't know. Miami has a puncher's chance. They're that puncher's chance.
Here. Yeah, they do got a puncher's chance. Hey man, I wouldn't be super surprised. Yeah, Jimmy. I mean, you can't count Jimmy out anymore.
Like, if someone in Miami got to the NBA Finals this year, I wouldn't even be surprised. Like,
no, it's 2-2 now. They lost that game. You know, the game where Embiid got his MVP finally, well deserved. But the game where he got it, they didn't do so good.
No, James Harden looked like he had PTSD from something. I ain't never seen him play that bad in my life.
James Harden is starting to be one of those players like. When he's hot, be afraid. When he's not, just walk on.
I'm about to throw a reference. You know who James Harden was reminding me of that whole game? Both guys are going to hate me for saying this, but he was reminding me of John Starks back in the day.
Oh, Lord.
James Harden, the way he was playing on game three. Give him some John Stark vibes.
I can see it.
I'm like, am I watching James Harden? Am I watching John Starks? I'm like, I was getting 1995 flashbacks.
Wow.
I have a question. Y'all know this new app that came about recently called Temu?
Yes.
So I went on there, I bought some things, and it's something I bought that was very, very interesting. And I got it just to collect it. Yes, and y'all know I'm a huge Yu-Gi-Oh fan.
Right.
I'm going to show y'all what I got. So they actually had on there the anime edition of the Yu-Gi-Oh cards.
Oh,
hold on, I gotta turn off this back screen first because it's not gonna show. Give me 1 second.
Yeah, it's not.
Let me turn it off.
Are you going WNBA?
Yeah,
take
it off.
I don't think I'm gonna be able to make that because some stuff came up.
Yeah, I think we're gonna probably check out a Chicago. Ooh,
hold up.
Hey,
blue eyes right there.
Let's fool that up here. Hold up. Okay.
cool.
And it's 100 pieces, so it's like all the cards you remember from the original series is in this set. And like, I'm gonna get
pretty cool.
And I'm gonna sleeve them.
Oh, nice.
Okay. Mm-hmm.
I just put like my favorite cards out first, you know.
Yeah,
sure. Makes sense. Of course, you.
Oh, I gotta show you the back. Person. Like this is really like from the anime.
Yeah, yeah.
Oh, that'd be good for cosplayers if they wanted
to. Yes, I thought about it, but I'm gonna just sleeve them because you know I have the binder of my Yu-Gi-Oh cards in it.
Mm-hmm.
True.
And it's other cards in here, but you know I had to get the Exodia pieces.
Of course.
Of course you got to, but of course, yeah, of course.
So only reason I got it was because Temu is real big on like discounts and getting people to use the app. It come in 100 pieces, 100 cards. 100 cards. Oh, so it's like it's really a lot of them.
Yeah.
You can make your own deck with that.
It won't work.
anime rules.
Yeah, you can, but it ain't no symmetry nowhere in here. Well, I mean,
did any of the decks have symmetry back then?
Other than Weevil and Rex, no.
No. Not at all. Yeah.
But Timu, I like it. It got a few things. I got some other stuff from there too, but I think that was like the coolest thing I got out of it.
Okay, I'll have to look into that. That's for sure.
And the more you buy, the cheaper it is, because the stuff all together originally was like $70. And then I got some other stuff that, like, after you buy so much, they give you like a little gift, which is like something real small. I got some more bracelets. And like, the end cost was $70, but all the discount stuff I got, it was like $11 for everything.
Wow. You know what? I'm going to look up that app later. That's a good deal.
Yeah, we enjoy
you too. So, since you're bringing up cards, hey, how's it going? How's it going, Fox? So, since we're bringing up cards, what is that?
You're in smooth.
Oh,
Tennessee, honey. He had to get the old school classic right there.
So, I finally.
Oh, I forgot that was out. Oh,
got my starter deck.
For One Piece, yo,
okay. I forgot about that.
Did you hold on?
I haven't opened it yet.
The app? Did you get the app?
I don't have the app. No.
Before you open it, get the app. It teaches you how to play with that specific deck. It teaches you how to play. So that's how I learned how to play. It is fun. I don't put it at you. Well, for me, I don't put it Yu-Gi-Oh because I've been playing Yu-Gi-Oh for years. Right, but I still will play it because I like the combinations and like. Even though you know what the colors do, it's so many different play styles you can do with the same. Like, I can get the same one he gets, and we can switch it up and be completely different decks.
Gotcha.
Oh, that's cool. That's pretty cool. Gotcha.
Yeah, so I was excited. I got that as a gift this weekend over Free Comic Book Day. By the way, if you do not know about Free Comic Book Day, it is May 6th every year. Free Comic Book Day.
I totally forgot this year. I know. I forgot.
When I say the hall.
Did you get the Ninja Turtle one?
See how thick this bag is?
Hey.
Yeah, the only one I remember is the good Ninja Turtle one coming out.
Okay.
Whew.
All of these.
I am at a deck.
All of these. There is the Ninja Turtle one. Oh, and then the place I went to, they had a dollar bin for some old school. So,
you got to let in. Hold on. Make the camera big.
Hold on. Let me pull it up for you.
Why you say that, Monty? Not even in Midtown Comic. That was my comic book store, too.
Okay.
So, I grabbed that one. I grabbed this one. Y'all know I'm a Hulk fan. And then I had to grab this one.
Grey Hulk versus Doom?
Yeah, Grey Hulk and Thing and Doom. Oh, yeah.
That's a lit issue.
No, I hope not. Okay. Hello, can you hear me?
But yeah, it was those were a dollar. They had them for a dollar for like the as far as the new ones I wanted to show y'all, they had the Spider-Man and Venom.
Venom.
Smurfs, Bruce Wayne, not so super, Umbrella Academy.
Umbrella Academy got
them. Yes, cool. Yes, they did.
See here, Fright Night, Amazing, Spidey's Amazing Friends.
I watched that. That's a cute little show. I've watched that a couple episodes. That's cute. That's a cute little show.
They had a Star Trek one. They had a Nightmare Before Christmas comic.
Ooh, hey, that would work as a comic book series. Hey.
So I just realized that somebody that we all know growing up is actually technically Marvel now. Well, they Marvel, and I kind of want to find a comic book.
Oh, this is for Jay.
You suck. I play you in Tekken for it.
You know I can't lose to you if I do that, right? You don't have to not care about our friendship at that point, right?
So this is what we're gonna do. We're gonna wait till the new Tekken come out. We're gonna play it, and we're gonna I'll put my mask up against it.
There's that Ninja Turtle one there.
Yeah, they came out with the 87. The 87 series has its own comic book series now. So you like the old school Ninja Turtles from the 80s? They have their own comic book series out.
Street Fighter 6.
Okay.
But yeah, a bunch of Animal Crossing, that like Captain Underpants, the I Am Stan comic book, the Stan Lee biography.
Wait. You did not just skip past Captain Underpants like he ain't the best superhero to ever come out.
It wasn't exactly Captain Underpants. It was the dog version, whatever his name is.
Okay. Okay. That makes sense. We rep Captain Underpants. The Flip-O-Rama? Are you really finna skip over Flip-O-Rama?
Dog man.
Speaking of Umbrella Academy, this might be a future topic one day. We should think of TV shows that would make good comic books. I'm just gonna throw that out there.
You made me forget who I was talking about. So the comic book that I didn't know that Marvel signed was Meteor Man. Meteor Man is Marvel.
Are you serious? I didn't hear that.
He has his own series. Then they redid the movie in the comics. Then they did a continuation. Then they had him going up against people like, I know they had him in the Spider-Man comic at one point because he's Harlem. I love TikTok, man. I learned a lot on TikTok.
you learn a lot. You know what, Jay? You made me think of something. You know, speaking of men, you know who'd be a good team up with? Blue Marvel.
Meteor Man and Blue Marvel. All
right. I like that.
That'd be a cool team up.
I can see that. Monty said they have free shipping for a free day. I did not know that. I prefer going to my local comic shops just to support them. You know what I mean? Show them the support personally. That's just me. But if they got them free shipping, bet.
Oh, that's good to know. I'll definitely look out for that next year.
And as far as Fox, sorry, it's been a long day. Hopefully you get to enjoy yourself, kind of power down a little bit today. Get some rest with us at least, chill out, vibe out, enjoy some laughs and good times. So that was Free Comic Book Day. I did a quick, I did an entire video, TikTok on the hall yesterday. Also got my first mech, my first Gundam, that I'm going to be doing a video, I'll be putting that together. Here soon.
I'm glad you said something, my friend.
Go for it, bro. You know how we work. You know how we work.
So I don't know if y'all have these places that have super deals down here. It's a couple of them, but I went to one last Friday. It's called Black Friday Sales, and everything in store was $8. In store was $8. This woman walked out with two brand new iPads for $8 a piece.
Hey.
What?
Damn, no, we don't have those. So yeah, what are we these? We definitely don't have those.
You would be surprised because I found out it's more because what happened is a lot of either returns or back stocks are in places that have Amazon Prime. Mm. So if you have an Amazon yard, you might have one. You just got to look it up.
Gotcha.
Okay, how she got the iPad? We went in there like an old school Black Friday. They told us to wait, don't touch nothing, and then they rang the bell. Everybody started moving. It wasn't Black Friday back in the day, but it was still Black Friday. She got boxes that didn't have no name on. They had a section where you could take the boxes to. They opened up, let's see what's in there. Two brand new iPads that worked perfectly.
Oh wow.
But I'm gonna show you what I got. I spent a little money. I got some Beyblades, of course. I got some headphones. Of course. Wife said, hey, y'all.
Hey, hey.
Hey, JJ.
She walked away. I got big legs. What else I got? Oh yeah, Rod. Got controllers.
There you go. Nice.
Got Pikachu on there.
I see. Hold on. Let me pull that up for you.
Lucario. That's electricity on there, too?
There you go.
Oh, no, that's right. No, that's
Lucario. This is a yellow Lucario. Right. Oh, that's what's up. But, yeah.
Let me show you what I got. A model. I think this was kind of cool.
Bro, I love that Martin jacket so much, bro.
I know, right?
Every time I see that. It's
not that you were black. You definitely see a Martin shirt in someone's house.
Right.
So...
I was looking at that exact one, but I didn't get it. I saw that exact one at the store.
I would not be a Digimon fan if I didn't get this for only $8.
Yeah. Oh yeah, no.
Nah, man. Certain stuff steal like that. That's probably at least $80.
You take it. Yeah. You take that.
Like a guy was looking at it and I'm like, I'm a person like I didn't need it, right. But if somebody else was gonna get it, I was gonna let them get it. I was just there to see what it was like.
Yeah.
And I'm sitting there looking at him. He just looking at it. As soon as he put it down, like,
right?
Yeah. Don't let him come back into his mind.
You
now.
Take that up off your hands.
Right. You don't need this. Let me holler at you for a minute. Oh man.
That's pretty much it. I got some other stuff too. Like the little lamp you put in the room to make the sky type thing. We got one of those. Got wifey a phone holder. I just thought it was a cheap phone holder. And I go on TikTok and the guy was doing his affiliate thing, and the thing is like $40. I got it for $8.
Yeah, there you go. Sound like you need to go there more often. That's what that sounds like.
Right. I'm gonna try, but I have to get there. You gotta get there early because you wanna be one of the first people in so you can look where you wanna stay in there before everything start. And I noticed, this was like a scout mission. I went there and I noticed people were going to certain areas first, and that's where all the boxes were at. And so it's like I had to get all the unnamed boxes first and then go for stuff that, I even got a VR headset. It's not a great one, but I just got it just because. And it's not even in here. Babe, where the VR headset at? I know that boy didn't take my
Lord
have mercy.
Kids.
Got my little nephew, got him a toy because he ain't had no toys and they was on the way up here, so I got him one of these. Did not know it making as much noise as it did, but it's actually pretty good for you. But
it's a kid toy, they're always gonna make noise.
Right. That's the point of it.
I got Bea a Koski lunchbox.
Yes,
heard that.
That she sounded happy.
Wait! I gotta show it. Wait a minute.
Okay.
Check me out.
Ooh,
that's
kind of
cool
right there. There you go. That's not bad at all.
That's kind of cool.
Yeah.
Yeah. So I'm gonna tell you something funny. I saw Koski and grab it. I don't know what it was. I just saw Koski and grab it.
Right.
And then, when I got a chance to, get to myself and start looking at myself, like, oh, this is a lunchbox. They would love this.
Right. That moment where you're like, okay, yeah, I still keep it.
I had more stuff in my buggy, and I just started. As I was in line, I'm like, okay, I'm not really going to use this. Okay, I don't need. I had put something down, and the guy went and picked it up. I'm like, yeah, he probably needed more than me. It was an experience. I know I'm gonna go back. Hopefully, you want to go back this weekend if I don't have to work.
Friday.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
So the days is so how it works on Thursday they're closed. Mm-hmm. Thursday was when they restock and change the thing around the store. Friday $8 day. Saturday $6. Sunday $5. And then it goes down.
Okay, I don't know what you just did, Jay, but something you moved. Cause it start being choppy.
Yeah.
Oh no.
There you go.
No, I was hitting mute.
I didn't move.
There you go. Nope.
Hold on.
It went back. Okay, it's gone. You're good.
I changed.
I got you.
But each day was a different price. But
you want to go there Friday or Saturday because that's close to the days they restock. That's why everything costs a little more. But it was an experience.
That's what's up. All right, y'all. Well, let's get into what we were here for today.
Yes, sir.
This campaign.
Oh, hold on. Wait, right before we go in there. Wait. Right before we go in there, I got to show you this real quick.
Go for it. I'll put you up in the mix right real quick. Go for it.
Hold on. So remember how I was talking to you about Timu? Look what they said on Timu.
The dice. Okay. Yeah.
That looks nice. For $18.99, that's not bad.
They have cheaper ones too. I just wanted to show the nose.
Yeah.
Oh, that's cool. You want to do color things? Oh, that's not bad. Not bad at all.
Oh, trust me. I'm not a dice goblin yet. But yeah, eventually I'm gonna get to that point.
Bro, these 100-sided die though. 100-sided, bro.
Yeah. Yeah. You gotta have at least one. Oh, those are nice though, the way those are set up.
Yeah.
She got a Sailor Moon dice. So Lonnie, when are you jumping into the campaign? I just need to know when do I need to start writing you into this campaign.
Yeah, we're always looking for people to jump the campaign, just throwing that out there.
No, that's nice.
I really like these. Mm-hmm. I like those.
Yeah. Those are real cool. Nice, yeah. Those look heavy.
$10. Well,
yeah, those 11. Look heavy. Yeah.
Lucky.
So my brother is the one. So this man, first and foremost, I have to put respect on his name. My brother is the one who got me into D&D. And he taught me how to play, he taught me how to DM. He's the person I usually have DM games for me, right, if I'm playing in it. Mm-hmm. He's also the one of the few people in this world that I would give my imagination over to and feel like he will enhance it. It's that bad. For those of you who know me, y'all know my imagination is crazy as it is.
Right.
Oh, that's what's up. That's nice. Forward. That's for when we get. That's for when we get an in person game going, when we setting up models. So
I'm trying to find some purple ones to look at.
Oh Lord, don't get them started.
As soon as I say it's home.
Yes, sir.
Oh, those are nice too. Yeah, those are nice. She said probably during the summer months. Got you. All right, we'll work on that. So he got me a pair of set of dice, and these. When I say these. Things have weight. I'm gonna pull it up here. Hold up.
Ooh, I like that.
These things have weight to them. Like it's like throwing a stone at somebody.
I won't want to play some crafts with those.
Right. Like it's like throwing a rock at somebody. Like it's a bag. But he gave me these and he said there's a tradition that he has and from the person who taught him and he passed it down. He was like, certain dice, the heavier the weight of the dice, the heavier the weight of the decision being made by the dice's roll.
Which I thought was
really cool, right? So the last time I played with him, I haven't played in a campaign in a little while because he's been busy and we're just not in the same state. But the last campaign we did online, he was testing something out and he had me play. I played a bugbear that was a druid of the Wildfire Circle, basically a fire-wielding bugbear, which is dangerous in any capacity. But the very last decision I had to make was about bringing somebody back to life. And so I used those dice for the first time. When I say the storyline was great. Sorry, it was just great. I had a moment there. It was good. But yeah, that was the only time I've used it so far. So I will let you all know if during this campaign I pull those dice out, so that way you all are aware of the severity of whatever's about to transpire.
Hey, I'm about to get some of these purple ones myself. These purple ones go hard.
Hey,
yeah, those are nice.
Relax yourself.
Yeah,
they got some ice ones. I was just looking at, and I like it, but the I think out of those, the purple ones wasn't the best ones. It was the blue ones before it being ice. But here you go.
Okay. Oh, yeah, no, those are nice. Right, let me move that over.
Oh,
yeah. I like that. Let me show you purple one. I'm going to show you purple ones.
I think the blue ones were better.
Yeah, blue ones. Yeah, that one works a little bit better.
Now, these purple ones, well, there you go. Christmas gift, birthday gift.
Okay.
Oh, now those go hard. With the gold.
I'm going to save them in my cart.
Yeah.
Those go
for later. Add to the Amazon list.
Mm-hmm.
There you go. All right. So let's get into this. As you all remember, you all were in the city, well, the tent city, right? Mm-hmm. With the Panthracians, the lion-like people, after you had just saved the princess, basically, of the tribe. You all are, you've partied all night, you've enjoyed the evening, the festivities, things are going good. You kind of, you know, just kind of relaxed. If I'm not mistaken, and let me know if I'm wrong about this, I believe Diesel was on edge just a little bit.
I'm an elephant, man. I don't trust lions.
Right. So I can't blame him for that because it just makes sense, you know. So he was a little untrustworthy, but you all were bedding down to take a good night's sleep. Silk, on the other hand, decided to go for a bit of a walk with the princess at the time. And as such, decided to possibly bring a situation back to the tent to speak with the rest of the crew about these gnolls again. Okay?
Look what Monty said.
Hold on, what did Monty say? Q, stay with the group. Yeah. hold on. She said, I feel like Q is most likely reason why you would bring out the heavy.
I say yes.
I can see it. That's
Wow, that's funny. Yes. Wusa. That was funny. So you all, everybody else went back to the tent. If I'm not mistaken, I don't think anyone else stayed up late but him. Would that sound? Does that sound accurate?
That sounds about right.
Yeah.
Because I know Jen went back early, and Jay, I think, was just kind of chilling for the most part. I think he left. So we're gonna start back up with Silk returning from his walk with the princess. Mm-hmm. You're just coming into the tent flat. Basically, you see, just like everybody else did, you find all your clothes are back. None of your belongings are missing or anything like that. They did clean your clothes from, you know, your hikes that you had. And so you can change back into your normal garb at this point if you'd like. And then you all can have that conversation however you all want to proceed. What's going on?
They still awake?
Are you all still awake? Is anyone still up?
I am, because I've been following you the whole time.
Okay. So wait. So if that's the case, I need a stealth roll then. That's gonna be the first roll of the day.
Roll for me because I forgot to get my tablet. Roll for me.
Then. Okay. I'll roll for you. Yeah. This is gonna be interesting. Okay. So what are you doing following them? How far back are you? What is the purpose and intent of the follow?
Just to block you, like I said, I'm gonna be doing.
Yeah.
Wow.
He did say he was gonna block.
So
he didn't say it. So okay.
Man of his word. We respect people who are men of their word.
Yep.
This is true. This is very true. So Jay, you are rolling stealth. And of course, it's going to make me reset everything because I didn't have it in here.
Okay, now my tablet's back on target. Let me reset it. If I ain't let me open the app.
All right. So you got a plus five to yours. You know what? I'm gonna give you this. I'm gonna use this blue dice for you. Okay.
Okay.
Is it no? It's green for you.
Yeah.
All right. I use this green dice for you. 9 plus 5 is 14.
That it is.
Okay. Let's see here. Yeah, Silk.
Yep.
What is your passive perception? Because you're really not paying attention and nobody be watching you right now. Right, so what's your passive perception?
Let me see. Plus 4?
No.
It's a senses. I think it's what it says.
Yeah, it's under senses. 14. Yep. 14?
Yeah.
Okay. So you do notice him.
Mm-hmm. Of course I do.
Okay. You notice him.
He's going to do it, so I'll
try. So are you just going to ignore him?
I'm gonna just ignore him.
You're like, normal? Okay. So yeah. He goes about the night. He talks to the princess. Jay, did you hear the conversation with him and the princess or no? Were you gone?
No, I didn't hear the conversation. I was gone by then.
Okay. Gotcha. So basically, they were just talking about the evening and they're talking about the day. And he was trying to basically holler at her real quick. And then she's worried about the Knowles. They have a.
And worried about Diesel as well.
And he's worried about Diesel. No, you're worried for a different reason. But yeah, she's exactly. worried about Diesel.
I wasn't worried also, though. Remember what I said? I said, oh, since she fascinated with this nigga, I'm gonna just let it go.
True. Out. But then she did give you the peck on the cheek at the end of the night and said she wanted to duel you when you came back, if you came back from the Noel quest.
She was gonna fight me because I'm strong.
So so I'm assuming so then if that's the case, Silk comes back and then Jen comes in a few minutes after that. Or Jay. Jay does?
Yeah. The Kaze.
Hey Kaze.
Jen, are you still up or are you knocked out at this point? And Diesel.
I'm still up because I don't trust him.
Okay. So you kind of sleeping one eye open, I'm assuming.
Yeah.
Okay. So then when you come in, Silk, what's the conversation you're having with him? Are you having a conversation with him about anything?
If they up, then I'm going to tell them that we're going to help Shorty fight off the Knowles and shit.
Okay.
Hold on, you telling us or asking us?
I'm telling y'all.
Oh,
that's between y'all. That's y'all conversation. Have at it.
Now, I'm going to just be like, hey, look, I was talking to Shorty. She really tripping over this shit. We already saved her. We might as well just go ahead and fuck around and fuck these niggas up. This is going to give us experience. You know what I'm saying? Experience points. And everybody who plays games know the more experience points you accumulate, the stronger your character gets.
Right, but you can't. You're the person. You don't know nothing about no experience points.
I'm just saying.
You can't talk on top of the table.
That's I know that. In life, the more you do something, the better at it you get.
That makes more sense.
I can respect that. So one thing, and like I said, most of this, again, y'all don't all know. When we're in game, you are the person. So it's not a third person conversation.
I know that.
I'm telling you, it's not a third person conversation. So I need y'all to have these conversations in real time, like y'all talking.
What did these guys promise us again if we take out these Knowles for them?
Are you asking me or each other?
Oh, I'm asking them first if they remember.
Okay. I think they said they was going to pay us or some shit.
Mm. All right. I'll do it for the gold. That's cool.
Yeah. Okay.
I think Silk has other ulterior motives.
I had ulterior motives. I don't know more.
He's trying to be like Lupin. He's trying to pull a loop on a third.
Once it became apparent that I'm not the main nigga, side character.
Go play your role. I get it.
But he ain't with this shit, so I can't really wing mad for him because he like, fuck this bitch. She a lying. So it is what it is.
Arguing that.
Right. You know what I'm saying? So it is what it is.
So okay. What are we doing then? So we're doing it for the gold?
Yeah, yeah, yeah. I mean, you never have too much money. You know? Mm-hmm. Especially when you're
so,
fucking adventuring around the world and shit.
So they, I do have a question. I kind of fuzzy. They know about our queen, right?
Yeah.
And what was that conversation again? I don't remember.
They said that she not they queen, but so they will go against us.
They not really messing with the queen like that. Yeah. So.
Yeah, they have their own beef.
Yeah.
We're more of an enemy of my enemy is a friend type of situation. That's what's going on.
Mm, okay. Well, I'm with it.
Okay.
All right.
So, are y'all just powering down for the night or
rest?
Yeah, I'm down to just get some sleep now.
Yeah, thanks.
Okay. Not saying that it's needed. But does anyone want to do a guard? Does anybody want to kind of stand guard, keep an eye open? Because you can't keep an eye open for stuff and you get a full night's sleep.
No, I'm sleeping.
So okay, so you're out.
Well, I'm sleeping
here. Okay. I'll stand guard. I'll take a chance with the guard.
It's up to you. I mean, again, you guys. I mean, if you feel comfortable, you are in their encampment, right?
That's so they've got guards. I'm overthinking this.
No, hold on. I will say this. I feel like they need us to be healthy to help them out. So I don't think that they will mess with us while we're sleeping if we're agreeing to help them.
True. That makes logical sense.
Yeah.
Okay.
All right. Oh, and then DM, just my bad. They did say that they were going to help fix our robot friend, right?
Yeah.
They said they would try to take a look at him tomorrow. Yes.
Okay. All right. All right. All right. Yeah, I'm just going to go to sleep. I'm not going to watch Marty.
Yeah, I'll say sleep. Okay. I want to get a good night's sleep. It doesn't hurt to have a good night's rest.
Perfect, perfect. All right, then everybody gets a long rest. So if you've got any... on the top corner of your screen, it should say something that says just long rest. And you can click that button at the very top, and that will reset everything, all your spells, all your health, all of that.
Okay. I'm looking at it right screen. Now.
Let me see. I don't see long rest.
It should be, well, I'm not sure what your screen looks like.
I'm on the app. But it
should say the top.
Yeah, the I just app. Hit it. Confirm long rest. I just hit it.
Yeah, same.
I'm trying to see.
Hold on, what screen is that on? So this is screen
number. It's on your character screen. It's at the top. It says long rest. It has a moon. Picture of a moon on it.
Yep.
Picture of a moon on it.
There's a crescent moon. So it just looks like
just say like short rest, long rest, campaign.
Yeah.
And the little anvil that you should see.
Hold up. Well, y'all on the app or the website?
The website. Well, I'm on the website.
Yeah,
I'm on the website.
Okay, I'm gonna hit view character on website.
Okay.
Smart. Okay, I'm on the website. I don't see it.
It's at the very top.
Yes.
At the very top, I see D&D Beyond. I see the menu.
Right. Underneath that, in the same line, is where your character
is
name.
Your name. Yeah.
I see manage. That's all I see. Character name manage, level 5 male, change from fire to rogue.
Look at your name and then look to the right. You'll see share, short rest, long rest, campaign, absolute pandemonium.
Okay, let me turn this off real quick so I can show y'all that I don't see that. And I know I ain't crazy.
Well, I mean, that's all debatable. Right, but.
All right, Jimmy. Appreciate your presence, my boy. Where do y'all see that at?
Oh, they got it. Hit the three lines at the top.
Feline top bow.
What does it say? It's flipped, so I can't read that because it's backwards.
Actually, hold on. I can fix that. Let's see. Mirror. Bow.
Okay, there we go. That works.
Collections. Maybe tools?
No, it's not any of those. Hit the three lines again for me.
Three lines. Okay, it went back. Let's see. I see everybody. Boom.
Okay. What does it say next to 13 to the right of that?
13 said defense and conditions.
What's under manage?
Manage, it says. Do you see a
campfire symbol?
There we go. I see it. Okay. Yeah. No. Oh, we took a long rest, right?
Yep. Long rest. There we go.
Take long rest.
All right.
I need to find it on the app. Let me see. Where was I? So we go to conditions. Oh, that's not it. I like that feature. Okay, so for future references, if y'all ever do get on the app, it's a campfire right up under here, right there. Yeah.
Okay, it's under that part. Gotcha.
Yeah.
Okay. Perfect.
Back to my food.
No, you're good. Okay, so everybody knocked out. Boom. Schooling. Mm-hmm. Wake up the next day. It's an uneventful night. You all kind of hear the revelry outside because they're still out there drinking and partying and they're enjoying the day. And so you all get a good night's sleep. You wake up in the next morning. You are preparing for, getting your stuff back on because you all did get your clothes back. So, readjusting yourselves and everything. And Yelena comes in. Well, she doesn't come in, but she comes to the door. And just kind of like, hello, are you all awake?
Good morning.
Yeah, we're up.
Do you mind if I enter?
Yeah, go ahead.
Sure, that's fine.
Okay, so she enters. She tries to be, she you noticed, those of you who were up and kind of looking that direction, you did notice she reached for the flap first and then stopped. And then ask for permission. So she's not, again, she's the princess of the area. She's not used to having to worry about that type of stuff. Right. So she was just kind of like, she's like, thank you. I'm sorry. I didn't mean to bust in. I wanted to say thank you all again. Well, I guess I shouldn't say thank you yet. Have you all, and she looks at Silk. Did you all talk about whether or not you all are going to be willing to help or able to help us?
Yeah.
For the right price, we got you.
We got your back.
For the right price? Well,
right.
I personally can't talk reward myself. I mean, I would be eternally grateful and so will my people, of course, but my dad is probably the best person to talk to about that. He did send me to come get you all. Whenever you're ready, he's at the main tent. So just feel free to make your way there. Also, and she looks over at Diesel, and you all visibly notice that she does not make eye contact with him. Okay. And she's just kind of like, do you mind if I take your friend out of the cart? Are some of our artificers said they would take a look for you?
Yeah.
If you think you can help him, go ahead.
Would you mind helping us move him? He's a bit heavy.
Yeah, I can do that.
Okay. So you follow her out after you get your stuff set up. You follow her out and you all walk towards where you left the cart, basically. He's been in the cart all night. Okay. Yeah. The rest of you are up and moving. Do y'all want to talk amongst yourself before you roll out? Do you guys just want to head out, head over to the main boss's tent?
Well, we might as well see. Well, he already asked us if we were up already, so I guess they want to send us off. So just say, let's just get ready. Let's make sure we're prepped to go. And
yeah, I think we need to talk.
And I know, meet with these quests. Hope I find a cool wind spell. So,
well, y'all, I mean, if y'all gonna talk amongst yourselves, feel free. Go ahead.
So, are we not just gonna, you know, recognize that she just looked at him that way?
Is I was gonna say something, but I wasn't gonna say something.
Did you all, so Diesel's gone right now, right? I'm assuming.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah. Should we be concerned?
Nah.
Maybe a little bit concerned. I mean, why would she look at him? But then it's. But he did say that, you know, they've had there's something going on. We still do not know, but we want to be helpful. We want to help.
After talking to her last night, I can assure you that she's into him.
Okay,
that's why she probably was looking at him like that.
Well, we know he hasn't been easy being here. He's been on, you know, high alert for other reasons, but understandable. I just think we keep a close eye on everybody else around him, particularly.
Okay, true. I'm with it.
True. Makes sense.
Okay.
So, when he comes back, if nothing happens, I think we should always, one of us should always be by his side just in case.
Okay.
It'd probably be best if it's me, because he's probably not going to observe Mike pay too much attention to me. He knows that I'm just here with you guys and I'm just on a journey to find wind spells. So. Might be best if I just observe.
That's cool.
So you're going to wait here for him to get back in?
Yeah, we're going to wait for him to get back before we do anything else.
Gotcha. So, Diesel, as you all go through, and I find, yo, y'all should be proud of me. I've been working with, sorry, this is a side note, complete side caveat. I've been working with Midjourney, right? Okay. And trying to get like images for y'all. Mm-hmm. And I think I got it. I'll let y'all know if it'll. Let me see if it'll pop up. Come on, yo, be nice.
While you're doing that, nice. I broke out because I just remember what he did.
I you can do what you want.
Not again.
Wait, what? What happened?
I just want to punch you. Just because.
He wanted to punch you for some reason.
Oh, I'm
just one of your slaps. Okay, so you have to. So I need you to roll an attack roll, just a straight unarmed strike, to see if you connect.
Hold on.
And also, we need a countdown. So how many do you have left?
That's what I was gonna ask. I forgot.
It was 17 total.
17 total. So this is gonna be. I'm gonna be 1 in 17.
Okay.
Okay, he said unarmed. Let's roll. It's an 8.
It's an 8. What is your AC? So,
it's like a 14 or something, ain't it? I remember from the last time.
Yeah, it's a 14.
Okay.
So you know what happened, right? So he
swings. He takes this wide swing. Like he thinks he's about to just tag the back of his head. And then Silk is just like, bro, for real? So that's one down. So here we go. I got the picture.
No, he slapped me before. This is the second slap. And the first one connected.
Oh, yeah, the first one.
True. So this is... That was 17. This is 16, so you have 15 left.
Okay.
So this is a general idea of kind of what you're seeing for Diesel as you're going through the city. Just general kind of
cruising down the street, my
six folks. That's such a dope fucking image, bro.
Right on.
We're proud of you, Panda.
Is that awesome?
I tried.
We're proud of you, man.
That's awesome. That's pretty cool.
Because, hey, the whole time when you were telling us what they look like, I was just thinking of mutes.
Right. So I found here, I'll give you this one. This is kind of to give you an idea from the night before. That's kind of what you were seeing. You know, they're just kind of around the campfire, laughing, joking, you know, just a bunch of lion people out there chilling and enjoying their best life right now. But anyway, so Diesel, as you're walking through the city, this is kind of what you see. Tents. And different color tapestries everywhere. You got people walking around, and again, you don't see a lot of guard presence. Most of the guards are lionesses, from what you're noticing so far. They're not, how do you say, they're not like the male, the male lions with the manes and stuff like that. It does seem to be like they're gone, like they're not there. Here's another one, kind of give you another how wide the bazaar area kind of is that you're walking through, and you're kind of just going through, and you're keeping mental note of kind of where you're going. Right, you remember where you parked the cart. You remember where you were, and again, your uneasiness yourself is kind of, you know, you're a little on edge with it. But you all get to the cart, no issues. She does try to start a little bit of conversation with you, just general chatting. You know, hi, how was your sleep? Did you rest well? Stuff like that. Do you choose to engage her in conversation or just kind of?
Yeah, I'll engage. You know,
then they wanted to say no.
Okay. So she's like, you know, well, I hope you all rested well. I know, and she kind of like looks at you up and down, like a quick side glance. Is like, I know our accommodations aren't for someone of your size, so I do apologize. I hope that you at least got a decent night's rest, though. And thank you again. Thank you again for you all helping us. I know this is not your problem, and for you all to be sticking your necks out like this, it says a lot about you, especially for people who follow the queen. It's honestly, it's unheard of here. So thank you.
What are the people who follow the queen typically like?
Well, I personally have never really met any of them. Just what I've heard from my father and my grandfather and, you know, the warriors who are not here right now. It's just that they're not the nicest of people. You know, they're kind of self-centered. They're just worried about their own empire and their own lives. And yeah. They usually end up being the ones who cause most of our issues. They don't usually help us solve most of them. So if I apologize if people seem a bit standoffish to you as well. That could be why once they found that out.
I see.
Well, maybe in the future you won't believe everything you hear.
Very valuable lesson.
Kind of looks at the ground and it's like, yeah, you're right. And she stops and like darts right in front of you and stops and drops down and like almost like a prostrate bow in the ground. Mind you, this is the princess of the entire encampment, so this draws a lot of attention. Because you're in the middle of the bazaar and the princess is bowing to you. I'm sorry. On behalf of all my people, I'm so sorry. You're right. We shouldn't have judged. And I hope you forgive us. I really, really do. Please, thank you again for helping.
I was like, all right, princess, you don't have to go that far. We're all good.
And so she slowly gets up and keeps walking, and you see she's got a little bit of a trot gait to her step now, a little dancy gait that wasn't there before. Like she says, as she's walking through, and you all finally get to your cart, and the beast, the warlock is there. He's sitting over there eating to the side. And all you smell is like, it's not rotted meat, but meat that's definitely been out for a day or so. You know what I mean? It's not decaying and rotted, but it's definitely got that heavy iron
meat. I imagine while eating though.
My bad, coach. And he's just slopping out. Think of like pigs eating.
Okay.
That's what it looks like. But it, again, he's a big hippo with rows of shark teeth, kind of. So he's just like in there. He looks at you and, you know, makes a little noise and goes back to eating. And he's just kind of over on his side by himself. But he looks good. He looks like he was well taken care of. And you all go into the cart. I need a strength check from you, though.
Strength check. All right.
Strength check. Because I need to see if you are you're able to pick this guy up.
Probably not. I got a 5.
Yeah. No. So you step up to the cart and you're just like, all right, I got this. Walk up. Oh. Oh, you stretch your back out. Just gotta stretch and limber up a little bit.
Not a hernia.
Let me try this again. Go ahead and give me one more roll for it.
I'm gonna go ahead and I'm gonna cast guidance on myself just in case.
Okay.
You know.
Yes.
All right. So I'm gonna do this. Oh, I probably didn't need it. But so I got 21 that time. Okay,
20. So what was on the dice?
19.
19. So you got 21 total, and then you got the guidance. So just go ahead and roll it anyway.
All right. Let's see. Where's that?
Plus 4. Is it?
Yeah, plus 4. All right. That's it's another one. So 22 altogether.
22. Yeah. So this time you, because you feel like you just did yourself a disservice, right? Yeah. It's like, I'm the biggest dude here. There's no, nah, forget this. Forget this, man. You plant your feet, put one foot up on the edge, throw them over your shoulder, and just start walking with him, like, you know, Macho Man, Randy Savage style. I'm telling you, man, you know, it's like, you had to, it was more so for you than anybody else, but it was more of like, I cannot do that. That was not cool. That's not cool.
But he hurt.
Right. I know. That first time, your back definitely pulled something. Definitely pulled something.
Yeah, it's not proud.
It wasn't an epic fail. If you'd have rolled a 1, you'd probably took some damage from it. But so you guys are walking, and she directs you. And you get to, like I said, you're going through the bazaar. You get to the this one tent. And it's one of the few tents that has like a brick mud clay wall backing it. There's a furnace that's in the center, and this is a group of about 4 different tents. Think of like a cube, right? But all of them seem to share this bricked center, and so there's a fire that's being stoked. As you walk past, there's fires being stoked in each one, excuse me, but they're all connected to the same chimney flue system that goes up in the center of these 4.
Okay,
basically. And so you're kind of gathering because you're starting to smell. You hear like tinking of metal workers, and you know you're smelling certain things from like some baked foods in the area. So you're kind of thinking that this may be where they kind of condense all the heat, being that this is a desert area. Try to condense all the heated items into one place to you know, keep it together. Yeah. So you get to the spot, and she's like, if you could just put him there, and as you walk up to the tent, there is an elder that you see. He's just an older lion, you know what I mean? Nothing, nothing too major. Actually, I did have a picture of him. Let me grab it here real quick. He looks, I'm not gonna say regal, but regal. Does that make sense?
Okay.
Like he looks like he comes from knowledge. Mm. I don't know if that's a way to put it, if that makes sense. You know, he looks like he comes from, he's a knowledgeable individual, and he's able to, you know, he has that ability. And so as you walk through, he's just kind of like, yeah, you there. What do you think you're doing? What is this contract? Oh my, is this the? And he just freezes in his tracks and is just staring, not at you exactly, but at you. But he's staring at the automaton. He's staring at your friend. And she, you know, Yildiz walks up. Yeah, yes, this is, and she turns to you. I'm so sorry. I do not know your name.
Diesel.
Diesel. This is Diesel. And this friend. Does your friend have a name, or is it just a robot of yours?
Honestly, if he does have a name, I don't think he's told us.
Yeah, and you all don't know his name. He's not given you all a name this entire time, which is something else that's been worrying all of you through this. Here you go. To give you an idea, this is kind of what you see.
Oh, okay.
Oh, that nigga majestic?
Yeah, yeah. He comes from, he comes from good stock. He comes from good stock.
I couldn't think of the line from Narnia because that's what I thought about first.
Mm-hmm. Right. Mm-hmm. Right. So yeah, that's what you see. And now again, all these people are humanoid lion people, right? Like
meat.
Creatures.
Meat.
So.
The meat. The lion meat.
Oh yeah, yeah, yeah. So he's like, yes, please, come put him here. And he when I say he clears the table, he like old school, like 90s movie, wipes the table clean. There's bottles and glasses flying off the table. Right, he just clears it. Here, lay him here. And
why does he give me Doc Ryan from Back to the Future?
Yes, exactly. Perfect. And so, like, you notice... what is your passive perception again, Diesel?
13.
Okay, that's high enough. You notice one of the bottles he hits starts a small fire on the edge of the tent when he knocked it over.
Okay.
And he doesn't seem to have noticed. He's like, yeah, yes, lay him here. Lay him here. Yes, yes.
You've got a little fire on your hands there.
Well, yes, I know, son. There's a furnace right behind me. What do you think we are? We're at the chimney stacks. We're the stacks. Of course there's fire.
Let me point at it with my trunk.
Okay. And, like, your trunk points, like, it goes literally right past his head, and he, like, leans a little wide-eyed and follows it, and is like, oh, give me 1 second. He goes over and starts patting out the side, and well, thank you, my boy. Thank you. So what have we here? Is he sentient? Please tell me he's sentient. Please.
He is sentient.
And he does a little finger steeple, like, oh yes. I have long, do you know how long it's been since we? And he stops again and turns from you and looks back at the automaton. And it rushes over to another table, grabs, like, they look like magnifying glasses, basically, right?
Okay.
And he grabs this set of lenses, and it's one. Think of, you remember, the old school measuring cups?
Mm-hmm.
And you know how they used to stack inside of each other?
Okay.
Right?
Yeah.
Think of it something like that, but it's a magnifying lens that can zoom out like those cups do.
Okay.
And so he pulls it out, and he starts clicking, and as he clicks, one other cup drops down lower and lower and lower as it's like zooming in on the different aspects. And he's just walking over. Yes, this is no, this can't be. This is, well, I mean, it looks like the instruction is, well, I'm not sure. Give me 1 second. Yes, please give me book 15. But uncle, there's like 2015s. 15 Zelda.
You know what
Zelda? Zelda? Really? Come on, Unc. You've forgotten your own books again? There's no book Zelda. I categorized these last week for you. It doesn't exist. Look! Do not subvert me. You know which book I want. The one on the end. That one. That one right there.
You know which one.
Here, Unc. And she, like, walks over. She finally grabs a book and off the shelf for him and walks over to him. And he starts flipping through, and he's like, yes, no. And he's looking at inscriptions on the, like, you can't even see these, right? But it seems like in the book, he's looking at inscriptions. But on the automaton, you just see scratches, right? Now he does again. He has this magnifying thing. So you're thinking maybe, you know, maybe that's what it is. But he's looking in the book. You see clear glyphs that are in here, and so he's like, "No, this okay, yes." And he's walking up, and he stops, close the book real fast, and looks at you and is like, "You do plan on leaving him with me for a little while, yes? You don't need this immediately, do you?"
Make it sound evil as shit.
Mm-hmm. You have until we get back from our little mission, and then we're taking him with us.
Thanks. Very well. Wait a minute. What mission would you all be going on? Please don't tell me they have you chasing those wild gnolls.
That's exactly what's going on.
And what of it?
Oh. My boy. And he looks you over. This time, the look is more of a concern, like a concerned elder now. And like he's analyzing you and like looking at your like your muscle contour and your general build, and then he gets to your feet and he looks up at you and he walks dead up to you. Now, again, you stand a good 9 feet, right? Like you're not a small individual.
Big ass, no.
He only comes maybe to 6'5", something like that. But when I say he looks up into your eyes and you feel like you're looking up at him.
Right.
Looks like that. Okay.
Like, he's staring into your soul right now. Mm-mm-mm. And it's not an aggressive, it's a worried, concerned parent.
Being an elder.
Right.
Makes sense.
Right. And so he's like, he takes the book, he puts it down, and he clasps you on the shoulder, like on your forearm, and he's like, "My boy, thank you. But just be safe. I've lost enough of our pride."
That's real shit.
To them.
That's some real ass shit, bro. This made me more glad that I made this decision.
When you return, not if, you will be the one. When you return, I will have not only your friend ready, but I will have something for you. Are you alone? Are you going by yourself? Okay, never mind. This is a madness. Are you going by alone?
No.
I'm here with a party.
Oh. Whew. Like he went straight from an elder to like the madman or crazy dude real quick and then came back. Okay. He's like, okay. I will have something for your compatriots. You better yet. And he goes and runs over and there's a wall. Remember I said there's like four. You walk past and it looks like it's a block of four, right? And he walks over to one of the walls. And he like knocks on this wooden door that it looks like it would open either into a closet or something, but it actually is a door that opens as he opens it, or as it's opened into the next room. And through it, you can see weapons. It's kind of like the armory, you could say. It looks like that's what's on the other side of, and bless you, whoever's sneezing. But it's the armory on the other side of that room. It's that next room in the tent. And he says, "Hey, do you have that one thing?" And he's talking to somebody in there, and you hear somebody kind of growling, talking back to him. And he turns and looks at you, and he says, "Is there anyone? This may sound odd. Is there anyone capable of wielding lightning magics?"
That's me!
Well, that is odd, but
it is funny enough.
As a matter of fact, there is.
There is. Okay. Give me one moment. I'll be right back. And he like dives through the door into the armory area, and you hear him. And their conversations with themselves literally sounds like lions roaring at each other. It's like their own language, right? And so that's what you hear during that. And Yona just kind of looks at you and she's like, I don't know what's going on over there, but he's extra excited for no reason. I've never seen him like this. Like, ever. You guys must be real special. Because I've never seen this happen with him. And he gets excited about a lot of things. I mean, as you can see, he's a researcher. You know how they get. But no, I've never seen him this excited before. And so he comes back through the door. And he gives you a dagger. And on it, there is a, it looks like an inscribed lightning bolt. There's like, was carved into the blade of it.
Okay.
And he's like, he says, I don't know what it does. But whoever, I've heard that if someone with the proper abilities wields it, it could be of possibly a great asset. So, yeah, I hope at least it helps. I will have something more impressive when you all are done, when you come back. So please make sure you come get your friend and those things. If my fool nephew does not repay you, either way, I personally will want to help and thank you. So, yes, go. Hurry on. The day is getting started. I'd hate for you all to... It is a bit of a trek. I will see you when you return.
Well, thanks for the dagger. I'll see that we can put it to good use. And...
Very well.
Farewell.
And so... as you leave, he kind of, you see him looking over the automaton's body again. And then like, right before you're out of earshot, right? Like right as you're leaving out the tent, the flaps, and it's open, right? It's not like there's flaps. It's wide open because it's heat, right? They want to make sure all the heat gets out. So it's open. And as you get to the edge of the tent though, he says, it's your thing. He's not even looking at your name. He just yells that.
What did he yell again?
It's your thing. Your thing. Oh.
Okay.
Bro, okay. I thought you were saying this one. It's your thing. Do it. Do it.
No. He just says it's your thing. And that's all he says.
I'll yell back. Is that his name?
Yes. That is my name, boy. I look forward to seeing you. Be safe.
Thanks.
All right. And so you head back with said dagger. Okay. I'm assuming you just you're heading just back to, back to the tent where they're waiting for you.
Okay. Yeah.
All right. So he gets back. Diesel gets back. You all, what do you guys want to do? I know you were waiting for him before you headed to the king. Yelena is still with you. Do you guys just want to head over or?
I'll tell these guys about the arrangement I made with the elder and I'll toss over the dagger. Okay. It's a little too small for me.
All like right. A toothpick in your hands.
It really is. All right. So, and I'm assuming you give it to Silk.
Yeah, I'll explain that it's something I don't know what, but something happens when you use lightning magic on it.
Okay. So you get an additional dagger, and you've got two on you already. Right?
Mm-hmm. Right.
What I need you to do is When you go, well, you're on the website, right?
Yes.
Perfect. On the inventory button, click on that, and then you should see like the search bar, and it says manage inventory.
Yeah.
Click manage inventory. And in the filter, type the word dagger. You should get something that says dagger of warning. You see that?
No, I have a dagger of venom, and I have a these are my daggers. I have a regular one. I have a green
dagger. I just put it on yours. Because you might not be able to see it because I've got extra content. So I just put it on you.
Can you see all the ones that I have?
I do. Well, I see you have two daggers right now. That's it.
Oh, my shit got six daggers.
No, so that's not yours technically. Those right there aren't in your inventory. Those are ones you can be added to you.
Oh, okay.
But so back out. Don't worry about it. Back out. Go back to your regular inventory. And you should see dagger of warning now.
Let me refresh, maybe.
You're fine. Go back to the actions, but actions page.
Hold on, I refreshed it. Okay, I'm on actions. Okay, yeah, I see it.
Dagger of warning. So that is what you got.
Okay, cool.
Okay. And then, like I said, there is some additional things. You want to let them know what that does?
Who, me?
Yeah, you want to let the team know what it does?
Hold on, let me click it. Magic weapon warns you of danger. Oh, let me tell them. Hey guys, so this weapon, it warns us of danger while the weapon is on me, and we have the advantage on initiative. Oh well, yeah, I guess that's right.
And also, any of your companions
within 30 feet cannot be surprised except when they're incapacitated.
Yep.
So I have
other than non-magical sleep.
Other than what?
Non-magical sleep. So if you're just sleeping, you still can't be surprised.
Right.
Okay. So I have a question. Does that affect my slaps?
It will actually. But you're not trying to surprise him either.
It's right. Not like your sneak attack. I always know it's coming.
Right.
All right.
Also, if you're sleeping, the dagger will wake you up if damage is.
It'll be an alarm that goes off. Right.
Yeah.
So in other words, he got danger sense.
Yeah.
That's what the dagger is. Mm-hmm. Right. Now the thing is though, because of your level and your abilities right now, you'll probably have to roll to see if it triggers you to notify you or not. You'll get the notice, right? Yes. You'll get the ping,
right?
But to know what it is,
actually, yeah,
right, to recognize it exactly. Now I'm letting you all know because this is the first time we've got an item in the game, right? So that's why I wanted you all to read it off so you guys can see what type of things you will be getting as time goes on. Normally, though, because remember the guy said he doesn't know what it does, right? So normally, someone would have to cast like an identify spell on it, or the person is going to have to, who you get it from, would have to know what it is for you to find out what it does. Otherwise, it would just be something that you would find out through the gameplay, and I would just give you these symptoms that you would possibly get as you were doing
it.
Okay?
Okay.
Cool. But yeah, so that's the first one. You get that one as a freebie as far as like just not having to cast any spells on it to figure out what it is. But from here on out, that's kind of what you would have to do.
That, yep. Okay.
So Jen, I got a question. Why did he get the first one? He didn't deserve it.
Lightning affinity.
He left the party and he gets the first. Come on now.
Lightning.
Technically, he got the second.
Who had the first one?
Because Deron's gloves spoke to him first.
That's true. Okay.
Out of us three, though, why did he get the first one?
Don't worry about it. Don't worry about it. There are other things coming. It's only a dagger.
It's only a dagger.
There are other things coming.
It's a dagger that helps all of us, though.
I do have a question, though.
What's up?
Okay.
Is it about the gloves?
Who has what gloves again? I want to make sure my notes are accurate on this.
I don't think I have any gloves. At least I don't think.
You don't have either. Right. I know that.
I have a purple and a yellow one.
But you're rocking the purple. Or you're not wearing either one.
I have one of each on
you
my
have one hand. Of each
do,
on.
Do you have them on?
Yeah. One purple and one yellow.
Okay. Okay.
And then I had the what?
Jay.
Yeah, green.
You had blue and green.
Yeah.
But I don't know if you put any on yet, though.
I haven't put them on.
You haven't put them on yet. Okay. So as of right now, Diesel's the only one who has heard the voice of his gloves.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Okay.
Okay.
Little Cap didn't hear when he was falling.
Wait, I was about to say, a nigga talked to me.
I was like, I thought somebody else did.
But you only had purple on.
You didn't have both. You only had one color. Only one of them talked to me
because I only took one side of each.
Okay, so then that's my fault because I thought you had both of the same one.
Yeah, so I have a purple one and I have a yellow one.
Okay.
Yeah.
So I'm not going to retcon it. It happened. Right. I'm not going to retcon it.
So just figure out which one spoke
I got to it. Yeah, I'll run it in from there. I know which one it came from. It came from purple.
Okay, it came from the purple. I was like, I heard a voice, but we didn't establish that it was the glove talking to me.
Right.
I don't even remember what the motherfucker said. Something about like
return the slap or suffer my curse.
All
right. Shit like that, yeah.
Okay, so you give him the dagger.
Yeah.
And y'all head out. So you're heading to the king. And you get to his hut. You, of course, are, you know, you hear him talking with everybody and the princess, Yelena, she goes in and, you know, introduces you all again. And this time, Diesel's with you all coming in. So his presence with, like, the people in there, they saw y'all last time and they already were kind of taken aback, like, gave y'all some room, right? Diesel walked in with y'all this time. And it was like y'all thought y'all had a presence before, like him being with y'all is like Shaq walking in behind the rest of the team. You know what I mean? Back in the day, it's like that.
Big ass.
So, you know, everybody's like, okay, oh, they're like kind of on awe and everything, and but they did. They talked to you. These people are all people you saw last night, right? Okay. Around the campfire. So there, it's not like an awkwardness. And so they're, you know, people are just, they're sitting there talking and, what was his name again? Berghoff comes over and he's like, yes, I appreciate you all again. Information. Yes. And he lays out a map for you. Right. And this is what the map looks like. I'll put it on the big screen here for you all.
Put it on the big screen.
So.
Nigga, is that Agrabah in bottom right?
No, but that is a city in the on the map in the area. He says, well, here is where we are here. Okay. The encampment. Well, technically, the encampment that you're looking for should be here. This is where we left our last team. They were setting up camp here. However, the Knoll Cave is here.
This looked like a long journey, nigga.
It's not that bad. You should be able to get some gold within the day.
I was talking to you.
Oh, no. I mean, if you talk, I'm thinking it's you talking, bro, because you are.
But I ain't going to say to the king, that's a long journey, nigga.
Why not? Why not? It is you. It's who you are. That is Silk. That is Silk. I actually, look, he ain't my the king. Queen and king to he his ain't face. My king. You hear me?
You right.
You dissed the king and the queen to their face already. I don't you expect
right.
much.
You right. You right.
So to give you all perspective on this, this is the cathedral where you all dropped in.
Okay.
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 That's the cathedral where y'all dropped in. This is about roughly where y'all got when y'all saw the rabbit shot.
Okay.
Okay.
Was here.
I wasn't there.
This is where, right, we know. You weren't there. This is where you all are now. So remember, you all kind of went northwest, yeah. right? This is where you all are now. That you know that there is mention of a city out this way and a city to the south as yeah. well. Remember, they're talking about the other two cities, right?
Yeah.
That they were talking about. So you're assuming, as you all are looking at this map, that one of these two places, one of these few places here that you're noticing here
mm-hmm.
are those town, or it could even be that big one over there. Right,
mm-hmm.
And then there's the one to the there's a big one to the south here, big one, a little one here. The knolls, though, he points out, are here.
Okay,
this is where the knolls are. I suggest you reach out and try to check this small encampment here. This is where our warriors went, and then they prepped before they went down to actually do battle. It was just outside of the range of their territory. Right, still within our area, right? We figured right. they'd be safe there, and they could do a one-time march right in and invade. We have not heard from our warriors
okay.
in the past 3 weeks.
Damn.
No, they did.
If we find your warriors alive, what do we need to say to them so that they don't attack us?
Be safe.
Ah, yes. That is a good question. Demeter will not be one to listen easily.
Okay, we have somebody accompanying us.
And in you saying that, Yilna steps forward. Father, I'll go with him. And he looks at her and is like, you just came back. Damaged. Broken.
What does that say?
I do not want to lose my daughter. My son may already be gone. I do not want to lose my daughter.
Was your son with that group that we're gonna look for?
He is Demeter, who I mentioned.
Yes. Oh, okay.
Yes. He is a rather proud. He's rather proud, rather stubborn. I
don't know shit. Where he we gotta go save Vegeta.
But he is rather proud. Although seeing his sister would help you all, it would smooth everything through. I will allow you to go, Yilna. You must not go past the encampment. You can travel with them there and ensure that they make it and know the directions, and then you are to return with whatever news you find.
Yeah, Yilna.
And she just looks at her dad and kind of gives a soft bow. I understand, sir. I will only go as far as there. Very well. And then he hands you all the map. So you all now have access to this map at any time.
Dun, 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 dun.
Hey, right. Level up. Yeah, got the map.
Now we got to put it in our own backpack. I'm the map. I'm the map.
I was just about to sing it.
We are showing our age here. I can suddenly say that right now.
Wow. That's funny. I'm the map. I'm the map. All right. So you guys get the map. He says, I unfortunately, I don't have a lot. He snaps his fingers twice, and one of the attendants brings out a small satchel. And he says, but I do have this. I hope it will be of aid to you all. And he passes over this pack. And in it, there are a few different vials. You all, they're health potions, basically.
Oh, nice.
You've got two regular health potions and two greater health potions.
We just got health potions.
Each or total?
Total.
Okay.
Total. So however you all want to split those up, feel free.
Well, I think that Diesel should get one of the greater ones since his size probably would loosen the effect of one of the regular ones. I'll take a regular one.
I think Six should get one.
You said what?
That's between y'all.
I don't think I need a potion right now. I think I'm fine.
Okay. One thing you all may want to decide on is this. Outside of your individual items, is there anyone carrying a collective grouping for you all? Or is everybody just carrying their own stuff?
I don't trust him to carry my stuff. He likes to leave the group.
He's lying to
you. Yeah.
So everybody's carrying their own?
Yeah.
Okay. So who's taking what?
I guess I'll take the greater potion.
Okay, you taking one greater?
Yeah.
I get damaged a lot. I'm going to take a creative potion.
Okay.
I'm all right with that.
Yeah, I guess Vlo can get the two lesser. Because Rod can heal, right?
I think I can. I think I have a healing spell. I think I do. Hold on. No, I don't. I don't have any. I don't have a healing spell.
Okay.
You know what, Rob? We finna find your spell book so you can learn some more spells. We need you.
Well, I don't have a wind healing spell yet.
Okay. So make sure you jot that down, what you all have. Okay.
Alright, I got
that won't be in the
inventory.
In your inventory right now. I gotta figure out how to add the greater.
I was just about to add
I added one to mine.
Yeah, is it a greater or a regular potion?
It was a greater.
Greater? Okay, it allowed you to? Okay, cool.
Yeah.
Cool.
So what do you do? You just go to manage inventory and edit?
Yeah.
Okay.
There you go.
Okay, so in my inventory now.
Potion of healing. I only see the greater. Oh, wait, hold on.
Let's see. Manage inventory.
There you go. Type in healing, and you'll see potion of healing, greater potion of healing, superior potion of healing. So you all got, whoever got the regular or the greater, just put that on yours.
So I don't see
superior. On mine, it's only greater, superior, and supreme.
So there's, right up here, I'll add yours to you for you. So it should be right above it.
So I only got those three.
So I'm adding greater, right?
You're taking a greater? Yeah. So you took a greater. Okay. Diesel took a greater. Silk took a regular.
Two regulars.
Jen took a regular?
No.
Or you took both regulars?
Yeah.
Yeah, actually, I didn't want no potions.
Yeah. Can I give him one since now we know he ain't got no healing spells?
That's up to y'all.
Yeah, I'm fine for right now. I'll be fine.
Okay. So you got them. They're there.
Did you add it to my shit? Because
yeah.
Okay. You put it in backpack or equipment?
It's in your backpack. It could go in either one.
Okay. Okay.
I don't have
it. I put one for Yusuf. One is in your backpack and one's in your equipment.
That shit is not showing. Let me refresh because that's
refresh,
what.
Yeah, because I'm updated on my end, so you got to refresh your screen.
Yeah, okay. Yeah. I was like, because that's what happened last time.
Yeah.
Okay, yeah, I got one in equipment.
I got that with Tinkerbot.
And then just when you use it, you'll click on it and then subtract one from it and go from there.
Right, cool.
Okay, so that's how that'll work. And I mean, so when it comes to potions, just a general, so you all know, if you decide to use a potion, it is an action to take a potion. So an action normally is an attack or something like that. It's an action to actually drink the potion, open it, drink it, and that's it, right? That is, that would be your turn, minus your movement and stuff like that. Okay. All right. So he gives you those. He bids you all. He said, do you have any questions? Anything else I can try to answer for you all?
Where can we get some stuff for the road?
What are you looking for?
You know, like extra food, water.
All of that. Yeah, you all have water skins. You all have rations. So he's like, that's stuff that you can pick up in the on your way to when you get to your cart, the building that the carts are attached to. They do have some rations, extra rations, and water skins there for you to take with you.
Do y'all have any weapons?
No, unfortunately, no. Nothing additional as of right now. So,
how much y'all backpack weigh, real quick?
So we're the way we're doing our campaign, there is no encumberment. There is no encumberment.
Okay.
Okay, so you don't have to worry about that part.
I was about to say, because my backpack 60 pounds.
Yeah.
59.5.
Yeah, that's why I just rounded it to 60.
Oh, I didn't know you rounded
it. Yeah. So don't worry about that in this campaign. In later campaigns, we may do it when we're trying to do it a little more gritty, but for right now, it's just
for the first campaign we chose.
Yeah, we just chilling. So. All right. All right. Anything else?
I think we're good to go at this point. I can't think of anything else we need right now.
I want a laser pistol.
Let's make movements.
All right. So y'all head out.
Wait, I think we should have a meal before we leave so that we have as much energy as possible.
Of course. Food. And he claps his hands. And the attendants go out. And you all sit there and you all just kind of general talk. You can talk for a little bit while you're waiting for the food. If not, y'all can just kind of, just a general chit chat. Food will eventually be brought. You all can eat. Is there anything you all want to say? Any conversations y'all want to have with each other? Or, saying anything before, while you're waiting or while you're eating?
Hey, Jacob, stop slapping me, nigga.
No, I'm good.
Okay.
Besides that.
Besides that, no. Okay, no, on that. All right.
No response. Jakaze, stop slapping me. No. Okay.
No. All right. So after that, you all, you go back to your cart. You hook up the wall park. You guys head out. Get your couple sets of rations. I will say you all get 2 days worth of rations, extra, and 2 days of water to go with it. They said technically, from what he said, you can make the entire trip in 1 day. Right, but it will be nighttime by the time you get there.
Right.
So,
gotcha.
Up to you how you all want to handle that, or if you as far as y'all planning for attacks and things of that nature. But for right now, you guys are headed to that first encampment. So, as you're going through, who's gonna guide the cart? Who's driving the cart?
I can.
Okay. Give me a survival check.
Survival.
I'll give it to you with advantage because Yilna is with you all right now. Okay. So she knows the way, the route.
18.
Oh, yeah.
Okay. Go ahead and roll the second one just in case.
I did.
Okay. That was high. Okay. So, yeah, okay. Cool. No problem. It took, a couple hours. It wasn't that long. Straight and narrow, straight shot. She took you through. She kind of avoided it. If y'all saw some of those mountainous ranges, she showed you how to get around them, where the right ravines were, stuff like that. You all made it through. No problem. So you get there. And as you get to the edge, you start seeing the tents in the distance. Mm-hmm. You notice that they're broken. Mm-hmm. Nothing seems to be standing upright. Okay.
Oh my god. Why did I think about Mulan when they went to go?
Yeah, exactly. That is exactly what you see. That is exactly what you see. It is torn to shreds.
Girl, we're fighting.
So, right, you just stop. Y'all was singing and dancing, and then the music just cut. So you stop and you get out. But this is where you all are. There clearly was a battle here.
Right.
There's bodies in places. There's weapons laying around. What do you all want to do?
We should investigate.
I was just about to say that.
We need to. We all need to investigate.
Okay.
All right. So with that, because everyone's doing an investigation, is there anything specific? I want each of you to give me something specific you're looking for. Either that, or hold on. Either that, or you all can do one group investigation check for what all of you find together.
What do y'all think? Want to do?
Investigation is pretty low plus. I could probably do a insight by myself. Maybe the rest of them, because I got a plus 5 insight. Maybe the rest of them could do a group together.
I got a
plus. No, it's either 6. All of you together or each of you individually look for something specific.
Okay.
I think we should look for specific things that give us.
Okay.
Yeah, that's another.
That works. Okay. So each of you tell me one thing that you want to try to find out that you're investigating.
Since Jakaze said survivors, I'll look for rations. For
survivors.
Yeah, I'll look
for rations. You're doing survivors. You're looking for rations?
Yeah, supplies.
Supplies, okay. Supplies and rations. Diesel or Jin?
Go ahead.
No, you got it. Go ahead.
Okay, I'll search for... we already got ration. Maybe I'll check to see if there's any like parts, maybe some type. Maybe it could be some broken glass. Well,
he's got supplies. He's got supplies. So that's all in that.
Okay, let me think about this a different way then. I can just search maybe the... Well, my character being all about wind, maybe the wind feels funny or something like that. Maybe something feels off with the wind or the oxygen.
Something in the wind, sense, anything like that? Okay. Mm-hmm.
I'll look for tracks.
Tracks. All right. Nice. I'll do that. Everybody, you need to look give me sales. A investigation roll.
All right. All righty then. Let's see.
Oh, that's a 7.
Okay.
Investigation. Need something good? Ooh, 21. 20. Ooh.
20.
13.
Hey,
fine. Shit. I got 21.
21. None of those were natural 20s, right?
No.
Right.
All right. So, as far as survivors, yeah, no, you looking around, it's a pile of bodies just everywhere.
Question. Both gnolls and lions?
Good question.
Yes.
Okay, good. Yes. Now I know what the gnolls look like.
Yeah. So both gnolls and lions. And you would have known that before, though, because you're a hunter. You're a bounty hunter.
Then, bro.
I know.
You're a bounty hunter.
Right. You'll see later. You'll see later.
But yeah, so like nothing, nobody, like you didn't see any breathing or anything. Everybody really, they look dead. They look dead, dead.
Not dead, dude.
But that's about all you're getting from that. As far as supplies go, I mean, you see the weapons that they had, you know what I mean? Some scimitars, some spears. You do rummage one body and find like some old meat rations, but they look more like they're not any good anymore. What?
And this happened a while ago, like roughly 3 weeks.
So you wouldn't know. You wouldn't know. You wouldn't be able to tell with that seven. That's the thing. So you, they're dead. It's not fresh. It ain't a fresh kill. But as far as how long, you wouldn't be able to tell. Okay. As far as the wins for Jen. You're kind of, and also you're taking off of the week, right? The last few days,
mm-hmm.
they haven't really been particularly windy from where you were. Like I said, you were only a couple hours away, right? So in general, they should be what you were experiencing the last couple days, last day or two, should be what is was experienced here as well, right?
Right.
No heavy winds or anything like that. You look around and there's no real sand blown over the bodies, right? It really looks like there's just kind of this decaying smell. Now, I will tell you that with what you found, yes, there is a bit of a decay smell in the air at this point, which means their bodies have been dead long enough at least for them to start decomposing.
Right.
Okay. So it's been a couple weeks now. It's been a couple weeks. So that kind of answers what Jay was looking for with his by merging those two together. Okay. As far as tracks go, yeah, you find tracks everywhere. Lion tracks, gnoll tracks,
track.
Your cart tracks.
track.
There's tracks everywhere. It was a pretty decent sized squabble, right? Track. They was going at it.
Not a squabble.
You do with that roll though, with the 21, you do notice tracks heading out in a southern direction, which is what you all were told is where they came from. You also noticed there were some tracks coming into the camp from all sides of it.
Damn, them niggas got ambushed.
The tracks that went south, can I tell if they were dragging something?
I don't
really think of that.
I mean, he got a 29. That's nothing.
There was not a, like, there's not like a body drag, but it looks like there may have been a cart.
Okay.
So, like, you see, like, a thin reel, you know what I'm saying? The wheel, wooden wheel, wagon wheel trail, kind of. Now, it is, again, it's been a little while. So, this was, in order for you to still see this, it was deep.
Okay. All right.
You see what I mean? Like, it's been a while, so the winds kind of moved some of this around. So these, whatever was in it, something is in it that was heavy,
right?
To leave that tracks for this long.
Okay.
But yeah, you did find it.
All right. Can we ask Yelena if she recognizes anybody?
What?
These are literally, well, there's not all of them. And you all look around and there's seven bodies.
There, I think there wasn't all of them. She didn't gasp when we saw the dead body, so I figure her brother ain't there.
She does not see her brother. But she says there were 14 total.
Damn, that's
happening.
Including her brother or
including her brother? Including her brother.
Okay.
There were 14 total here. I only see seven. I don't know if they took the bodies. I don't know why they would take the bodies. Or if they're still alive. I don't know if but no, my brother is not among them. However, and she kicks one of the bodies over, and this dude was on roids.
Dang.
Like, they've all been pretty muscular build. You know what I mean? They're lion people. Mm-hmm. This dude was jacked, though. Like, he would have gave Diesel a run for his money.
Dang.
However, for this one to fall, Mom must have been here herself.
The mom of the nose?
She goes by ma'am. Mom. 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 Ma'am. That's just what they call her. I don't know. And it's M apostrophe A-U-M. Mom.
Oh, okay.
M apostrophe A-U-M. But that's she recently took over, is our understanding. And since then, everything has changed. They're not as reckless anymore. They're not as misdirected or unguided. It's almost as if she was sent for a reason. I don't know.
They got a strategy now.
Have any of you ever seen this mom before?
Good question.
No. Anytime she stepped on the battlefield, none have escaped.
Oh. Uh-oh, that's interesting. They didn't tell us that.
None have escaped.
Is she like that?
I don't. And it's not that she has been the one, from what we understand. It's just her tactics are amazing. Mm-hmm. Now, Diesel, I need you to give me a history check.
History. That is a 19.
Hey, my nigga on it today.
So,
can these start rolling for me? Because, yeah.
The name rings a bell. It tickles a bell. It doesn't ring it loud. It just kind of tickles it. Like a wind chime on a light, breezy day.
Damn, not the wind chime on a light, breezy day.
That's the kind of recollection you have from that name.
Okay.
There's a lord
of the rings
back home that you feel that name is associated with, but you don't know why. That it seems to be triggering something, but you don't know why.
Okay. All right. Okay.
All right.
So. But yeah, other than that, no, that's kind of what you find. You get your direction, and then you all, what do you want to do?
Well, we don't know how long ago this attack happened. What time is it?
The day?
Yeah.
I will tell you this. You all were also given, and Yilna is kind of the person that's kind of giving you this as well. You all have been given ways to kind of tell time frame of the day here, because like we said, it's pretty much overcast the entire time.
Oh yeah.
But from what she gives you, you're coming around noon.
Okay.
Right.
It's still early in the day. And Yilna's like, if we leave now, we can make it by dusk. We can make it to their encampment by dusk, to the caverns. But, I mean, the caves are their territory.
Aren't you supposed to be going back to your dad?
Take your ass home.
We are fully rested. We could go now and surprise them. Yes. And you see her start reaching for her blades.
My surprise attack is always a good idea in retrospect. It is something that can be worked on or can be used. It's not out the realm of possibility.
Jin understands. And there's power in numbers, yes?
Again, that is true. That is a true saying.
I don't want her blood on my hands if something was to happen.
Big facts. Now she gotta go home, bro.
So we're, no pun intended, we're headed to the Lion's Den.
Yep. No, she's heading to the Lion's Den.
But didn't you? Never mind.
I can be of help. I know you all found me in a bad situation, but I really can be of help.
It's not that. We need you to report back what we saw here to let your father know what's going on.
Yeah, the less people we have, the better the surprise attack is.
You do speak truth.
And if you're able to get back to your father, who knows, maybe you can come back and help with the backup. Right.
Reinforcements.
Fine. If you insist. But please, she kind of looks at all of you. Please be careful. I feel like this is my fault in some way.
It is, but we're not going to blame you. No, I'm just playing.
She looks so dejected. She turns around. I will head off. And she turns around and starts jogging and drops to all fours and takes off running through the back door. Y'all came.
She'll be alright.
She'll be alright.
She'll live. Better her feelings in her throat.
You know what? That's a shirt.
Right.
I'm about to explain to her.
That, I'm gonna leave that alone because that can go 15 different ways. Anyway, yeah, stop, Jay. Stop. Anyway, all right.
So, the other way is better to throw.
See, stop. There we go. I knew it. So someone y'all take it off. I know, right?
I'm cool. Take it off.
Before we take off, what is our plan of surprise?
Right. Who's our tactician?
Good question.
I usually just run in. As we get closer, we can come up with a plan.
I may have
when we actually see it. Ooh, okay.
I mean, I've seen enough no's to change it to one. Element of surprise.
Mm-hmm.
See what information I can get.
Yeah, our Chingling can go in and investigate ahead of time. That could give us even more of a drop.
So it's not a polymorph. That's the thing. It's not a polymorph. So you still have to look human. Like, you know what I'm saying? You can change like skin color, eye color, stuff like that.
Boo.
But you can't turn into the creature. Yeah.
Oh, so it's not like Ben 10.
Yeah, that would be a polymorph spell.
Yeah, I'm going to get that. That's on my list to grab.
Well, you know, I did grow up in an assassin village. I got a couple stealth tactics.
So, we know we're headed to the den. Of course, they're going to be guards because they know they attacked a camp. So, I think we should... Diesel? Your big ass got to stay back farther.
Yep. An elephant cannot be sneaky.
All
right.
When we get close to the camp, I feel like me
he
and...
He should be the lookout. If he's bigger than him, maybe he can see ahead of us.
I think me and him should be able to try to infiltrate because we're probably the stealthier ones. Y'all two should sit back. And we got to find some way to signal them if we need them to come in, though.
Does anybody have a message spell or anything?
Let me.
I just found out I can't change the other being, so I don't care.
No message spells.
Hold on, wait. Lightning boy, you ain't learning.
I'm reading.
The man ain't learned carrying yet. Just when y'all see big lightning, know y'all gotta come through.
Nah, not at his level.
Ah, boo.
Hold on, wait. How? Okay, so I have
a spell. You got Thunder Wave.
I do, and I also have Chromatic Orb. which has a range of 90 feet, and I can throw like a little lightning sphere at towards them. Once they see it, then they know to come.
Okay. I mean, you also have thunderclap, which can be heard up to 100 feet away.
Yeah, but that would
warn. That would be that would ruin the element of fire. Yeah.
Exactly.
So hear me out. One is for like when we need them to just come through. But the thunderclap would be if like we're in trouble. Like if you get caught, not me.
Right.
If you get caught.
All right. So if we hear
how y'all want to do it, you know.
So let me think. If we in trouble for sure, then the thunderclap.
Okay.
I'll probably throw. What do we want to alert them to, Jakaze?
So if we find that they have prisoners, we alert them for that. Okay. If we find the remaining seven, and if we get into something where we can't get out.
Okay, so if we get into something that we can't get out, I'm going to thunderclap. If we find the people, I'm going to throw a lightning one. And what was the other joint you said, Jakaze, if they got prisoners?
Yeah, and we also need to see about finding a way if we can get them in or a weak point in their defenses. Because they're
think y'all are missing out on one key thing that y'all have at your advantage, y'all have at your disposal.
What's that?
You got a druid.
Druid?
He's talking about me.
Oh, you're a druid. That's I be forgetting because, nigga, you an elephant.
He's a barbarian druid. So he has wild shape. He can turn into a small creature.
Nigga. Oh. I really forgot this shit because he an elephant, bro.
Right.
I'm with
that's what makes it so crazy.
I'm with Silk on that one. I forgot, too.
Yeah.
Hmm. Honestly, I forgot too. I don't even like using wild shape, but I guess I could do it.
Hey, irony, an elephant forgets he can do something.
Hey, like, why would an elephant want to turn into a mouse? Think about it. Like, you that's what he can turn into right now.
All right. So if I turn into a mouse, I can at least go in and scope the place out and get a rundown of it, and then I can report back to everybody, and then we can go from there. What do you guys think about that?
That's a good idea.
Yeah.
And then we can make another plan outside of that.
Yeah.
Wait, but you said gnolls are like hyena type?
Yes. So
so that should work because I don't think they really gonna be trying to eat mice. They probably need something bigger
than hyena type. They would need about Timon and Pumbaa? Meerkat human
size thing. They would need something that's got some body to it.
Yeah, so
now if they see it,
yeah,
they might, but they're not near. Normally, they're not going to go after something that small. Right. Let me see here, though, because there's a list of beasts that you can turn into. So let me see. So anything small you could think of, you know, baboon, deer, badger, owl, nothing that flies.
Small, nigga.
Weasels.
This nigga crabs. Said anything small and then said baboon, bro.
Yeah, small.
They're smaller than him now.
Right, they're smaller than him.
Right, but nigga, elements
are
fucking baboon coming.
You could do a giant badger, which is medium sized.
Don't be picking shit with the word giant in it.
It's not that big, but it's big enough. You gotta remember the size of creatures in this world.
But that's the thing. Remember what I just said, which was, oh, they not gonna eat mice because that's too small.
Yeah, I'll probably stick with it. I can't stick with anything that flies.
I'm letting you know what options you've got. You know what I mean? So you know. Like a mastiff.
Nah, he trying to get this nigga eight, bro.
Let's see here. Yeah. Yeah. A blink dog. You could do that.
A blink dog.
Uh-huh. It can teleport.
Oh, you can teleport.
Yeah.
Niggas can teleport.
But I can't change it. I don't
believe you just an OP ass nigga, bro.
Nah. So with wild shape, as you level it up, you can change into larger and larger creatures.
Ah, I see.
So, but he can only do it twice.
Yeah.
And he can't do anything but that creature's stuff. So it's not like he's got, you know what I mean?
Oh,
so
it's the specific creature that can teleport.
Right. The creature can teleport.
Okay.
Right.
Because I'm like, nigga, come on, bro.
No. It's a blink dog. That's what they do.
But I'm like, nigga, you making this nigga.
No. Like a boar, axe beak. So yeah, you get the abilities of the animal.
Okay, cool.
Yeah. But as of right now, you can't do anything flying or anything that swims. So,
man, that blink dog might be a little too big. Otherwise,
yeah, that's gonna be a decent size.
I'll probably stick with the mouse.
Okay, go to mouse.
I guess we got to get there first, though.
Yeah,
makes sense.
All right, so you are going to turn into Zerat. That's what you will be.
That sounds like
Pokemon. You do have dark vision, so that'll help you.
Okay.
You do have a bite attack that you can do if you happen to hit it. You will have one hit point, though. So if you get hit, you turn back into an elephant. Basically, anytime you have any polymorph or wild shape, stuff like that, if you all get those spells later, you get the hit points of the animal, and then whatever damage you take, we subtract those hit points first, and then the rest of them carry over to your regular form. You just basically turn back into yourself, wherever you may be. So if you're in a hole as a mouse and you get hit, you turn into an elephant in that small mouse hole.
Wonderful.
Which can be dangerous for you.
Oh, no.
Think about that. You can get yourself in some compromising situations. I'm just saying.
I'll keep that in mind.
All right, keep that in mind.
Duly noted. Right.
So you guys head down and you head towards the caves. And I think right there is where we're going to end tonight. You all heading into battle, basically. It'll end up being the evening hours. When you get there, basically the sun will just be about to set by the time you all get there. All right. So I think that's a good stopping point for us. And then next time we go, it'll be the actual, hopefully, you never know what'll happen. You might make it, you might not. We might find something else that happens. Who knows?
Who knows?
Who knows these days? Maybe find a new lioness.
Y'all might get lost.
Someone might get dysteria.
Right. No, you did not do that. Did you really just say that?
Yes.
You little made it Susan too easy. Died of dysentery.
That was
easy. On Dragon Ball Z.
Find out next time on Dragon Ball Z. All right, y'all. But yeah, no, I appreciate everybody sticking with us. Hope you all are enjoying it. We are enjoying ourselves as we play. So
yeah,
hope y'all enjoy yourselves. This is our first run through. This is my first large DM campaign. So this is interesting for me because this is like me creating my own world, not using a pre-scripted thing. So this has been interesting. This is mostly their first time playing.
Yep.
So this is most of the first time playing. So if you all are interested, then let us know. If you can be around for a campaign or two for an episode or two, let us know. You know what I'm saying? We're always looking to have guest appearances for people and stuff like that. So keep us in touch. Oh, we have a new blog website that is up and going. It is still linked to the main page, which is pandaofpandemonium.com. So you can pull it up from there. But it is the Pandemonium Pulse. That is our blog site that we've got going. as well. So any updates or topics of anime, gaming, tech that revolves around it, motivational stuff, meditational stuff, you'll see blogs about all those kinds of things on there, as well as any topics that we may have talked about on the show. If there's anything, additional information that I may come up, for example, there will be one about Red Hulk from a show we did before that'll end up popping up. You know what I mean? If we talk about it, you may see something there about it. Or any news clips or stuff like that we may talk about on the show. You may end up seeing blog posts about it there. All right. Well, you all enjoy. Anybody got anything to say before we roll out?
Ooh, I got some news.
Shoot.
So, y'all looking at the new hired TA of FIU.
Okay.
Oh, that's what's up.
All right, man. Congrats. Congrats.
My master's for fucking free.
Nice.
Ooh. All right.
Oh, that is awesome. Go. Congrats.
With that being said, much we go to Miami. We're staying with vocab.
Oh, yes. It is in Miami, so.
Oh, word?
Yeah.
So now we got to plan a trip to Miami.
Now we gotta fucking let y'all know when I'm settled in, and then
hey,
all right,
we're not going around hurricane season, just so y'all know.
No, that's definitely not gonna happen.
Do it.
No, all right. Well, sounds like a plan. We have to figure out some cons down in Miami and post up.
Mm-hmm.
All right, well, again, appreciate all y'all from coming through, and we will catch y'all next time. Hopefully, as long as nothing goes wrong, we'll have a regular show next week. I don't think there's anything going on as of now, so we should be fine. But we will see. I'll put it up on Twitter for not having a show next week. I will make sure that gets posted for you all, so that way you all are aware. Okay? All right. Well, you all have a great rest of your evening. Enjoy. Get some rest. Hope the week goes well. We out.
Stay blessed.